This is like one of those streams where if you were here, you're gonna just be like so happy you're here. This would be very funny. Come on in!
Hello.
I'll get her in a second. She's fine. Chat!
How's it going?
Dude, I love you guys, chat. Y'all are so funny. Just want to make it very clear. This is like just for fun. Like I asked Jason if he wanted to just be on a stream for fun. And you know, and I may have been like, hey, I haven't streamed in a while. Like I need a fun stream at some point. And you actually said yes.
Yep. I'll come over. It's been a while.
It has been a while. It's been a bit. How is this real? Dude, I don't know. Because, like, we've gotten to know each other, like, a bit over the last couple of years. So it's just been cool.
I'm worried now. I put my glass there next to all your tech stuff.
No, it's fine. It's totally fine. Chat, can you guys hear us okay? I just want to make sure. I need to get this cat out of here, though.
I'm going to get the water.
Mess. Hey, you're so cute, but you were like disturbing an internet moment. She has no idea. She truly has no idea that she was like ruining that moment.
So the stream funny. Is mine!
Chat, I told you it was gonna be a fun stream today. I told you it was going to be fun.
We're going to do some retro games, right?
Yes.
Nice.
Yes. I was already showing them, like, one from my childhood.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, that was, like, the big thing is, like, I was like, okay, want to do retro games. How do we do something that's, like, that I don't have a lot of experience with retro.
Okay.
And not to say that you're old. I don't want to be mean. Not to say you're old, what's the best way that I can have actual conversations about old things?
Mm-hmm.
Like really, like I'm talking like before I was born type games.
Okay.
And I was like, okay, that'd be really sick if I could get you for that. So I was playing Vector Man.
Nice.
But I think I'm done with Vector Man for now. Cause that was one that I was like terrified of as a kid.
Mm-hmm.
And I was showing chat that. But
we're rocking the 256 colors, right?
I almost don't know what that means. What do you mean by that?
You got a limited palette of 256 colors. Before, like 65,000 and 1 million.
Yeah.
Back in the old days, 16-bit Genesis, Mega Drive days, right? Is that what we're doing, right?
Yeah.
Nice.
I just don't know what any.
So you've got a limited palette you're playing with. See, because we're not doing a formal thing, we can just nerd out and talk about some techie stuff as well.
That's what I want. That's like the goal of today. Mm-hmm. And like, and that's the thing. I like mods help us today. Today is just like actually just like having fun. Like that is the whole goal of today.
Yep.
So, like, we might like bounce back from some of the same things you guys are saying in chat and all that sort of thing. Like, I don't know. You've never done a stream like this before,
nope.
So it's kind of funny.
It's long. Yeah. Normally, I've come here with a message of things I've got to talk about. Now it's just kind of have a chat.
Now it's just his friends.
Loving it.
It's just his friends chat.
Yep.
That being said, the thing I'll show you about Vector Man, if I like cut over to it really fast.
Yeah, go for it.
So this is the thing I noticed, right? Is that the reason why this game is so hard, and I was telling chat that, is because I can't do, like, because it's D-pad, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
There's, and you can shoot diagonally.
Oh, you're supposed to be able to do...
Well, I can't do, like, 360, like, shooting.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And like, that's something I never, like, really thought about too much. I'm like, oh, that makes this games back in the day way harder.
But that would have been on a Mega Drive controller, right? Or the Genesis, sorry. Wrong country. In my country, Mega Drive. For you guys, it was the Genesis, right?
Well, yeah, which I think we can look at. Hold on. It's in this like little thing, like this little... This...
Streets of Rage! We're doing two-player games. We've got to do some two-player
Yeah, we're going to do... We're going to try to do a two-player thing, chat. Mm-hmm. But like, okay, yeah. So if that's the actual controller, yeah.
So that's your Genesis, right? But you see the color? You got the red on the front? In the different regions, there was a different color. So I think in Europe, it was white. Red is Japanese. And I think blue was American. Did you guys have a blue strip? There's different colors on that strip there for the different regions.
Right here?
Yeah, for the Mega Drive, yeah.
I did not know that.
Yeah. And it says Genesis there, but I say in England, it was called the Mega Drive.
Right. I knew that.
Yeah.
But that's weird. That's really cool.
And if you had different consoles, if you put the same cartridge in, it would relocalize. Like Streets of Rage.
Yeah.
They got a Japanese console, put it in, it changed the graphics because all the graphics were in there.
What? It's yeah. like the only thing
you had to blow the cartridge. Right?
Yeah.
You had to have that on the Master System as well, which is the version before we got to the Genesis. It was the Master System. I think that was... Well, we're 16-bit there, and the Master System was 8-bit, which is even less colors you could play with, I think. Right.
Dang. It's like the only thing that I like... So when it comes to like games that are like really different, like in Japan and like really different here,
yep.
Like one of my favorite games of all time, I always told you, is the Nier Automata, Nier Replicant.
Yep.
And they like did that with that game where it was called Gestalt in the West.
Sure.
And I always thought that was so interesting that they like fully, and it was like, it was like a different character too in the game too.
Mm-hmm.
So I always thought that was super interesting.
Well, it's like
you play as the dad in America, because I guess Americans, we really like, we want to be like the dad, I guess. I don't know.
One of my favorite games, which was for us was called Nemesis, but for you guys it was called Gradius, right?
No idea.
Yeah. Gradius was a side, and it was Gradius 1, Gradius 2, Gradius 3, and then there's Salamander. Which chat is another version, yeah.
Chat, does anybody know what he's talking about?
Am I full of it? Tell me, chat.
Twinkie said, I love Gradius.
I love Gradius, right? It was called Nemesis in England. Or it might have been in Japan, actually, but I learned it as Nemesis.
Yeah.
And then version 3, it was supposed to be Nemesis 3, and it came out as Salamander, and then it came out, I think it was then Nemesis 3 afterwards. Yeah. It's going back a bit now. This is before you were born. No, it's not.
Well, that's the thing, like genuinely, like, a lot of the... My like when I we started going in like, okay, childhood games, and I'll get to yours in a second.
Mm-hmm.
Like, a lot of my childhood games are stuff you made. Really? So I'm like, oh, well, I guess I can go back further, but like that's...
Well, you gotta remember, so at the time, going back again to, you know, 8-bit, 16-bit consoles back in the day, the number of colors you could put into a sprite was limited. And a sprite is one of the icons on screen, and there was a limited number size as well.
Yeah.
And then you had to start learning how to do what's called UDGs, user defined graphics, and that's how you could make those big Nemesis or Gradius ships. It wasn't sprites attached together and synced, because you'd see this kind of overlay trace, but when you did a UDG, you could do big stuff. So Ghosts and Goblins, Ghouls and Ghosts, all that kind of stuff. You start to see large characters with multicolor backgrounds. And what you had to do was you had to sit down and you had to color in all these blocks on a graph paper, and say, well, this is all the red, and then this is all the green, and this is all the, and then you put them together, and that's how you made a multicolor character. And that was using UDGs.
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
How do you remember all this?
Because I used to, when I was a kid, so, you know, my mom and dad could only deal with myself for so long. They used to send me off to my uncle's house on the weekend.
Yeah.
And he was an accountant. But he was also doing programming on the side, right?
Yeah.
So I started programming when I was like 10 years old. And I'd go over to his house and he'd get me to color it all in. And then we had to translate all the boxes into hexadecimal and then put it in. And I was on what's called an MSX computer, MSX Microsoft Extended, which people don't know about, I'm sure. But MSX 1 was very simple. I think it was like 8-bit at the time. And then my uncle got an MSX 2. And that's when I played Metal Gear on the cartridge, the original cartridge. But you could program it in, you could then move the characters around, do simple animations, do simple fills and all that kind of stuff. But that was the olden days.
Chat, all of this knowledge at our fingertips. That's so cool. I love it. You started programming when you were 10?
Yeah. I was, I really wanted to make games from a very, very young age. So 10 was, I remember my uncle used to say, you're too young to learn programming. That just... Can I swear here?
Yeah, you can swear. Okay.
It just pissed me off to no end. So there was this big book, which is kind of like the ultimate guide to MSX coding. And I just memorized the whole thing, like front to back.
Yeah.
Just to try and impress my brother and my uncle. That's what kind of got me in. Because I was the little squirt kid kind of going, please, I want to make games. And they're like, you're too young. And I was like, there's nothing that drives me more than being told you can't do something. So
yeah, I can relate to that.
Yeah.
Chat knows, I've told the story many times about... Yes, it is.
Hey, enough with the ancient. Come on. 8-bit and 16-bit wasn't that far away. Yeah.
But I was going to say, let me get my headphones on and make sure audio's coming through, because I'm always weird like that. I want to make sure it's all good.
Yes, Jason took that personally.
Yeah. Yeah. But I've told the story many times to my chat. Like, when I was young and I really wanted to make videos, So I had similar thing, but like it was videos at the first, mm-hmm. right? Because obviously everything totally. Happened over the years.
Yeah, yeah.
And I got to a point where, like, I was put in front of a counselor, and I always tell a story because I just want to tell you guys, do the career and passion that you want.
Absolutely.
I remember being sat in front of a counselor, and they're like, "You're never gonna make it.
Yeah.
Making videos. You're never gonna have friends making videos.
Yeah.
And it's just like. They're like, oh, all those people online are not real.
I know it sounds like it sounds. What? You know, it sounds cliche, but you know, life isn't a dress rehearsal. You get one go, right? Take yeah. those risks, make those choices.
Yeah.
I had the same experience. I was in the north of England. I come from a town called Warrington, up in the north sure. northwest of England, in the county of Cheshire.
Look at full screen.
And I had the same thing. I went to the guidance counselor and said, "Well, I want to be a games programmer." Yeah. They're like, "Nah, I think you should be an electrician." You need to be an electrician.
Why did they choose that?
Because they were like, well, you like games, you like computers, okay, electrician.
Oh, they're like, okay, we'll do something useful.
Yeah, right? And I was like, but I want to make games. No. You're from Warrington. No, you're not gonna make games. And I was like, please. So that was just a continual quest, which was like, okay, how do you get the foot in the door? You know, how are you gonna find place? And then the shining beacon on the hill for the northwest of England, for me anyway, was a company called Cygnosis.
Yeah.
And Cygnosis was based in Liverpool in a place called Wavertree Park. And as a very young kid, I kind of moved out from Warrington, moved to Liverpool, to the big city, to the big smoke of Liverpool. it was Liverpool and Manchester were the two big cities. And I just hang around. I just like, well, please let me in. I ended up getting a job at SCE, which was Sony Test. So I was a tester on Parappa the Rapper.
No shot.
G Police.
You tested Parappa the Rapper?
Yeah, the original Parappa the Rapper, yeah.
What?
Yeah, yeah. But you had Sony Test there, and on the right, this kind of gleaming green glass building, which was Cygnosis Liverpool, the head office.
Yeah.
And then the other side was Bizarre Creations that did all the Formula One games. There was a guy called Martin Chudley, his company. They did all the Formula One games at the time through Cygnosis. So I was trapped on either side. So every time we'd stop testing, I'd go out to see if I could just hear programmers talking. I just wanted to be near them and creep them out.
Yeah. It's like it's probably like when you go to, I don't know, I've had that sometimes when you go to, again, sorry, it sounds kind of cringy when I go like, yeah, I had that experience at like TwitchCon.
No,
but it's like when you go to like places like that and you meet other creators and you go like, oh, just, I mean, there's something very magical about that aura around people like that. And then you want to soak it in. I mean, that's why we, over the years, like we did all that group stuff and people made like groups and everything because there was just a magic to that. And you would learn something just, even if you weren't making like a video that day, mm-hmm. you would hear like, you know, like Pat or somebody just be like, Oh, I have this idea. And it'd be like, all right, tell me about your idea. Let me bounce back on you. It's not my day today, but sure, I'll, I don't know. It's kind of, sounds so simple, but just being around people and absorbing information is so good. Like just getting out there and I don't know. If you're in college chat, go to like join a club or something. Oh, it's really helpful.
Here's the thing I had, which was, so I had a massive inferiority complex. So I just used to think, I want to be a programmer, but there's all these super smart guys and they were all great. And I thought, well, what I'll do is I'll just keep working. I'll keep getting in there because those super smart guys are better than me. Mm-hmm. But if I just keep working and keep going, you know, I was thinking like tortoise and the hare. Okay, they're really fast, but I just keep going. I'll get there, right? So I just sneak in. Every time I'd get a job, I used to get my poor managers. I used to get them to write me letters of recommendation. So like Cygnosis, I ended up working at Cygnosis Manchester. Every summer holiday, every break, I used to go in there on a Friday night. Program I was doing, taking C and turn it into to RISC code for the PS1 at the time, I think it was. And then just sleep under the desk and then kind of start again and then come back on the weekend and come back and then do school, right? And then every summer holiday, I'd go there and kind of work on a project and a different thing.
That's so funny.
But I'd then say, okay, write me a letter of recommendation because I just think, sooner or later, they're going to work out I'm an imposter and I shouldn't be here.
Right.
So at least I'll have all these letters. And if it all goes to shit, like they go, I used to work in games, at least for 2 minutes. Yeah.
I felt that for sure. I've had that many times. Imposter syndrome is like the
And it takes about, worst. It takes about, like once you're in the industry doing stuff, what I found, it took me about like 10 years before it kind of finally kind of calms down. You're doing that and you've got successes and you've got people saying, oh, this is great. And you're still like, they're gonna find out that I'm not supposed to be here.
I've talked to you about that before. I've definitely had that for sure. Because mm-hmm. like, especially when you have like your weird way of getting into the industry and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like, I guess probably everybody has like their weird way of getting absolutely. In some ways.
Absolutely.
It's everybody has their own thing. They're like, oh, that's gotta be weird, right? It's like, no, everybody probably found their way somehow.
It's really important. Like determination and a passion to do something is far more important than any knowledge or any experience, right? That passion to drive through. And so,
yeah.
you know, when I'm looking for people or I was hiring people into teams, if that fire is there, you can teach anything to anybody, mostly, yeah. right? But that drive...
it's like the drive is what
that's
makes
the thing.
That happen.
That's yeah. the thing. And that's what I used to look for with people I used to hire, which is like, am I seeing that fire in the eyes? Am I seeing that passion? Because that's what's going to take you through the hard times. No matter what happens on a project, yeah. you're going to get into hard times. It's that fire that will get you through. Not going to be the knowledge, not going to be your experience, because there's times when all that falls apart.
It's like
passion, right?
It's like book smart's really important, but the drive is like...
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I remember, like, there was a day you told me that, like, I want to say it was, like, was that, like, a Comic-Con or something, like, mm-hmm. years ago? And I remember a conversation we had, because mm-hmm. I was in school, and I was juggling both, and I still got my degree, chat. I still did it. Which is
important.
Good. Which is good.
Stay in school, kids.
To stay in school, please. but like, I remember having a conversation with you just about like, oh, well, this is what I want to do, and this blah blah blah. And I remember you kind of giving me that. It was kind of like, hey, like if I, you were saying like how important, like how cool it is when you see it somebody self-taught themselves something, mm-hmm. because you can tell they didn't just do it because someone asked. They did it because they, and not to say you can't get a job if you never self-taught yourself and you actually went through school. Like I imagine like. You're a doctor, you probably should. You
yeah.
probably should go learn. Like,
you probably
school,
should go learn.
But there's a lot of things where it's like, you probably want to have your like small project, especially in the creative field.
Because it's important to learn the rules to then learn how to break them. But
yeah.
You've got to learn the rules first. If you try and just jump to breaking them, sometimes things go wrong. There's nothing to
yeah.
fall back on. There's nothing to check what you're doing. So learn the rules, and then you can move past it and go, right,
yeah.
I can break these rules. It's an art principle, right?
Yeah.
We learn about, you know, a character is 7.5 heads high and yada, yada, yada. And then you can start playing and messing around. One of the big books that influenced me, there was a book called How to Draw Characters the Marvel Way, which was like a Stan Lee kind of thing. And I loved it because it taught that principle, which is like learn the kind of underpinning of the art principles.
Yeah.
And then it teaches then, okay, and then this is how you then come away from that. This is then how you define your own style. It's like martial arts, right? They teach you all the katas, they teach you all the moves, and then they say, once you get to black belt, and you think, I've made it, and they go,
yeah.
no, now you've got to work out what kind of martial artist you are. Now you've
yeah.
learned the kind of traditional stuff. You have to then go over another route of exploration where you find out who you are. So creatively, as a programmer, as an artist, as a designer, learn the basics, learn what you're doing, and then work out what you're trying to express, what you're trying to put into
yeah.
the
it's like you learn it, then put your spin on it, and
mm-hmm.
you have the drive and passion to do so, and then that
absolutely.
Helps you stand out
yeah.
of the crowd.
And it helps you when you get to some of the kind of the rockier times, because you know, you can always move back to, well, these are the fundamentals. And the fundamentals of either the storytelling, design, art, programming,
yeah.
they're there for a reason. They're a guidance to when you're playing with stuff, right?
Yeah. The fun, Satchel said the fun part is finding your own style.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Oh my gosh. I mean, well, dude, I love how we can just, we're like, hey, let's play retro games, and we're just like actually having a podcast. Also, like, how is the setup right now? Like, are you good with this, or you want to?
This is awesome. It's great.
It's very like, you know, we make do.
It's a little green guy in the corner.
No.
Out of camera shot.
Chat, do you know what he just pointed at? I'm not going to show it on the stream, but he pointed at the Twitch Pepe.
He's got beady eyes staring at me. Sorry, I'm not up on internet culture, so I'm probably just pointing at something I shouldn't have there. But
no, it's like
okay.
it's the emotes that everybody uses on Twitch.
Oh.
Like it's fine. It's
okay.
Fine.
Okay.
It's fine. It's like it, have you ever heard of like Monka S?
No. Is this where you just start saying a whole load of words that I don't?
There they are in the chat.
Okay, here we go.
It's like Monka S is like, it's like oh, I'm, there's a lot of different variations that have happened over
oh
the
my
years,
God.
But it's like, in a lot of ways, like streaming culture
mm-hmm.
has like made that little character, like the, like, that's like the viewer
okay.
embodied.
Okay.
That is the, that's.
I can learn this new thing.
Like,
oh, look, it's got. Nice.
Yeah, that's if they like spam an emote a lot, mm-hmm. it'll show up on the screen. I might turn it off if you guys get bad, but like they'll try. Like I have like a.
We're not doing an adult rated stream here. We're keeping it nice and above board.
It's just right? It's just little emotes, but the yeah. Yeah, that's really funny. I have an emote of me when I had an allergy attack, and that's
nice.
Let's just make that content for some reason.
That's cool.
Chat, show him winter. Chat, do the pet.
Is this just like you're controlling the message? Chat, I want you now to do this.
Like they'll like Jason, you're like the kind of person that, like they will literally do anything you say. Probably like if you're like do this emote.
Mm.
They'll
come work for me, all of you. Come, come, my people.
Look, there's my cat. There you go.
There's the cat. Okay.
Yeah. Then there's a little pet. See the pet one.
There we go. I'm on my way. Nice.
I love the people coming in. They're like, "Is this real? This is not pre-recorded, guys. This is live right now. This is live. We have 200 people in here.
We can show the time. It's, yeah. We're look at this.
My watch died.
Oh. God.
It's 1:36 p.m. Pacific Standard. Oh my gosh, the cats are trying to get in. Okay, so why don't we transition things into like actually showing something that you wanted to show?
Because yeah,
Jason had things that he wanted to like I was like, because I can go
Revenge of Shinobi.
Wait, let me go to this really fast, and let me also just for the heck of it, let me
get a shuriken.
Oh, dude. Okay, I'm gonna move the face cam chat so we got more. Oh, I'm messing with stuff I shouldn't mess with.
Oh,
right
look
now.
What he's doing.
But it's okay. Let's just get rid of my logo because I don't need this.
He's doing acrobatics without a net here, people.
You're gonna see a bunch of things you shouldn't see, chat. I mean, it's fine. Let's do this. It's probably like, there we go. It's much, much better.
Let me out of the box!
Anytime we've ever done something on camera, Jason, mm-hmm. I'm so sorry. I always, like, you're always, like, in the, like, my camera's always positioned like this.
Mm-hmm.
And so, like, I always look massive on the screen.
That's good, man.
And I'm like, I want you to be on
camera.
I like
to be the guy in the background. I'm fine with that. It's all good.
Okay, something like this will be fine, right, chat? There you go. That's pretty good. We can roll with that and see if I can drop it a little bit just in case there's something at the top of the screen. This is streamer stuff.
Yeah, man. It's fascinating. It's a whole world I don't understand. I could probably spend this whole thing just going, so tell me what this me this program's doing. Tell me how you're doing it.
Like, so yeah, like just I don't know. This is why I love this stream chat. It's really chill. Namu donated $25 to me and said, so nice for Jason to invite JC onto his stream.
Just a minute, they're sending you money.
Yeah.
Nice.
I tell them not to.
More! Send us more money!
No, don't do that, chat. Don't do it. I know you will because you said it, but don't do that. I told you guys you don't have to donate.
I'm causing trouble already. Sorry.
That's what Emmy does on my stream. She'll be like, chat, donate. don't do that, chat. It's fine. I appreciate everybody subbing, though. I will call everything out later, but, you know, for the sake of it, let's just...
I'm giving you problems already. We don't even start playing yet.
Yeah, because they're going to donate, and it's going to be like...
I'm kidding.
We can't promise we're going to read everything, okay, chat? Because you guys are naughty sometimes with your messages. So, we got to, like, just keep it light. Keep it casual. This is a fun time. Let's, like... This would be sick to do again sometime. Let's not do anything. Don't be bad. Don't be bad, chat. Don't be bad. You guys know. Okay. Anyway, so I... have this going. Let me also if do you want headphones?
I have them. They're ready to go. It's okay. I need to preserve the bald spot. If I put my headphones on, accelerating my I'm gonna turn into like Scott Evil slowly as my hair recedes away, and so yeah, I'm okay.
I've always said like I enjoyed the bearded look.
I'm doing the glasses look today.
Yeah, no, yeah. I love it. It's very, like, it's good because we're talking about, like, all these, like, analytical things about games.
That's right. You look more like the nerd that I am.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
But, yeah, if you want them, there you go. But also, like, I hate that they always, like, take over so much space on my mm-hmm. on my face. Okay, so this was really cool. Like,
Altered Beast. Sorry, I was doing my ESWAT voice then. That's a different thing.
Yeah, there's a game on here called ESWAT that Jason was like, oh, dude, yeah. ESWAT.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, what? Okay,
we're going two-player.
So, like, I could sit here and do Sonic stuff like I always do to my stream, but we're not going to do that today. Yes. Let's actually be different, chat.
Yeah.
We got loads of stuff.
No, there's one, because you gave me a heads up of what...
Oh, yeah.
I think we should start with Alien Storm.
Alien Storm, chat. Alien Storm.
we're gonna go old school. This is back to, you know, me playing in my kind of mum and dad's living room.
Yeah,
on that Mega Drive, that was fantastic. On a TV that is like that big.
Yeah.
which is a cathode ray tube. That was the thing you pick up and be like, ah, and it was always front heavy.
It's like the...
So please don't tell me when I say cathode ray tube, you're like, what? Please don't say that.
I don't know what that is, chat.
Oh my god.
Maybe I did have that. I just didn't know what it was called.
The big heavy TVs back in the old days.
Like that.
Yeah, the kind of deep things. We used to have to move them around dev studios, and they were always front heavy, and always someone would drop one, and it was like, oh god!
They're saying CRT.
Yeah, CRT, cathode ray tube.
Chat, you are gonna make fun of me. I just don't know.
What's it like? They used to. There was one of the first kind of machines that I got excited about. Was Silicon Graphics workstations, which were these high-end PCs, as Indigo Irises and these other things. And they used to have monitors that were so big, these things used to give off x-rays. Like, you could put it near a white wall and put your hand there, and you'd see the skeleton on the wall because they're giving x-rays off.
That has to be bad.
Like, don't work too close to those things, but they were...
Well, that has to
be bad. I don't want to kind of be bringing shade on Silicon Graphics now, but it was like back in the day, way back old. It was... those were powerful things.
Like, it almost like... I wonder if some of that stuff was, like, dangerous. Like... In terms of, like, your health being next to that stuff all the time.
You know, I didn't turn out too bad.
You just ascend. You just literally, like, ascend out of the chair.
Yeah.
Okay, so Alien Storm. Alien Storm, all I know is that it's two-player, so we can do this.
Yes.
Right?
Give me a controller. Oh, I've gone blue. I'm like, oh, wait, whoa. Oh, wait. Oh, come on, we're missing the intro.
Alien Storm.
The intro cutscene.
It's going to be so funny. You're going to have to be on...
Am I going to be Emmy? Am I?
Yeah, you're going to be on Emmy's account.
Okay.
Why is it... What?
Oh, there you go. Two assigned.
Why is it doing like... Oh, my... Like, did I just like break... Okay, we're good. I almost broke my analog stick.
We're missing all the...
Sorry. Ah!
No, don't...
You let's reload. Is that, I think it's doing the like the preview.
Oh, okay,
the preview.
Okay.
How do I eject cartridge?
Okay. Now we're going to talk about CRT. So some of the standards. So we have TRCs and TCRs in the games industry. In other words, a set of rules that platform people tell you to kind of do. We used to have to put in that the intro screen would go into a video. Why? Because on CRTs, if you left the image in, it would burn into the TV. And then even if you switch the game off, the image, if it stayed static, would last there. So it used to be CRTs we had to put in after so many seconds, like 30 seconds or something.
Yeah.
They would load a... that's why you had like COD 3 and those kind of things. It would always go into a sequence if you just left it on the start menu.
It's like, it's almost like you guys were giving like a screensaver.
Yeah. Because it would burn into the screen.
Yeah. You don't want people being mad at you that happened.
Yeah. Well, you know.
Probably still happen.
That would be bad. Well, it doesn't now in modern kind of screens, but I think we still I don't think it's a TRC or TCR anymore, but we used to do that all the time. We had to.
Dude, that's so cool.
Yeah,
I love it.
Okay,
chat, the trivia today is like absolutely unreal. I love it. I think I press arcade, right?
This was a long time ago, so I don't remember.
Why is there's a like a PvP one? I don't know what that is, but
yeah.
I think
let's do arcade, and I think I can jump in.
I think that's how it works.
Yeah. Oh, there we go.
Okay, two player.
Yep.
This is 1991.
Nice.
Oh Jesus.
Oh okay, get to pick
okay,
who we are.
So I'm on the left, chat.
Yeah. Okay, who you gonna be?
I'm gonna be her.
Okay, I'm gonna be. It's between him and him. I'll let chat decide. Who should I be?
Oh, I think it just
too late.
Chat, you're not good enough.
Not fast enough, guys.
Save the people?
Save the people. Okay, let me go learn the controls. Ah!
Don't press that. Did you die immediately? How do I move?
We're firing all the special weapons here.
Oh, okay, okay.
This is special. Let's find the buttons first.
Okay, so square is special weapon. What is that?
Just, where's my... There's running. How do I?
I have a flamethrower.
Just a minute. Where's my... What button are you firing?
I'm using
X.
I'm using X to shoot.
Oh, there we go. We're off. We're off.
And then circle is dodge. Okay, and then off. Square is like the energy stuff.
Okay, we're off. We're off.
I think. What is
we
that?
We just spent all our special weapons though, unfortunately.
Jason, what is this?
Man, it's only gonna get better. There we go.
I'm gonna turn it a little bit lower so you guys can hear us better. Wait, so this is legitimately one of the first games you ever played?
Yeah, well, one of the first. This was a little bit later.
Oh, you go
on.
Even further back.
Oh, yeah. I think chat will only have a certain patience for like 8-bit graphics and, you know, 16 colors, you know?
I guess I'm close range. Are we both close range? Is that even a thing?
You got to get up on the thing. You got the special weapon, but I think there you go. You used your special weapon.
I just wasted it, didn't
yeah.
I?
Oh, here we go. We're gonna go first person. We're gonna go first person. Here we go. There we go.
What? What?
Come on. You've done some first person shooters in your time. Come on.
Yeah, a little bit. Just a little bit of them. What's the 1P, 2P right there?
Is that lives? Or energy? That's just energy. Oh. I think the energy builds up and then we can do the special weapon attack.
Okay.
Yeah.
Expel.
Which we'll need for the boss, I think. It's going to be a boss at the end of here, if I remember. It's a big slug thing with like lightning things off the top.
Dude, I keep pressing that button. Hey, it works.
It does work. We're just going to need it later though.
Jason said, that is cheating. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't press the missile.
No, you can do it. It's just, you're going to need it later.
What in the world? Okay.
Oh, look at that. I just used I had a flamethrower out of my foot and a rocket out. Did a bit of rocket out of the back. Oh, look at him. Oh,
whoa.
Trash can's turning into.
That's very like Men in Black vibes.
Yeah.
Like just.
Oh, yeah.
Like they're hidden.
Yep.
Okay, I don't have any ammo.
Well, that would be the problem, right?
How do I get ammo? What?
There's only so much I can carry you.
I'm just...
It's good, the boss is going to come.
You literally...
If I'm remembering back now, there's a boss coming.
You have a like an electric whip and a gun, and I have nothing.
No, you got stuff. You got like a... Doesn't she have like a... She has like a rocket launcher.
Wait, I can fast forward the game?
I'll do that.
That's cheating. That's definitely
cheating.
A cheat.
That's cheating.
Okay.
Come on.
I just got eaten alive.
Oh, we're going to... What's the button for the special weapon?
Square.
We need some help.
No. I don't have enough.
I don't have enough energy. I'm out of energy. Oh. Continue.
You're dead.
I'm back in.
Okay.
Back
okay.
In. Oh, here we go, boss. Okay, boss. Ready. Oh, here we go. Here we go.
See,
this is what we needed to... This is what we needed to
what
save.
Is that?
This is what we needed to save those special weapons for.
Well, you can
there
do
we go.
It.
I did it. Oh. I did one of them. My special weapon is blowing myself
up.
Yeah.
That's sick.
Yeah.
It's like 2D.
You go around the back.
Oh my god. Okay, I don't have any ammo, so I'm like, I wish I could do more.
am I the only one?
I can melee.
Well, come on then, get in there.
Okay. There we go. Oh. I should try to dodge. I should keep dodging. I'm so dead. I think I...
Get in, because if
okay,
I die, then we're dead.
Okay, how do I press start again?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I might have my flamethrower back. Yes. That was it.
Yes.
Let's go.
Get him.
Oh, they're still alive.
Yeah, got energy. You get him.
Dude, I love that you...
Now we're gonna run.
I love that you remember all this.
Whoa! I remember this.
Okay. What? Dude, this is like a mock speed zone.
Oh,
in...
jump into the air. There we go.
Chat, I'm not gonna say it. I'm not gonna say it. I need to chill with the references.
Okay.
Oh my god.
There
Wait,
go.
There's actually thing. Oh, you can jump. Circle's a jump.
Circle's a jump?
Oh, yeah. That's sick. So if you see something coming. Oh, shoot. Okay.
Okay.
Oh, I like that they have like variety to it.
Yeah, man.
That's cool.
That's the trick. Just kind of mix up down.
Yeah.
You know, mix up your campaign, as they say.
It's
right?
It's really like a thing that's stayed through the test of time. Like, mm-hmm. You need to have. It can't be monotonous.
Well, we were just talking about this, right? The principles. There's certain base principles.
Yeah.
About, you know, how to keep people engaged, and it's.
Oh my god.
Just when they think, okay, I know where I am now, it's like, okay, throw in a little bit of a bonus.
Yeah, throw in a guy that can grab you and throw you
into
the game. Yeah,
it works on AI, it works on level formulas, it works on art, it works on all these things, right? Oh, watch these guys. There we go.
We got the trash can people again. Trash can slugs.
Yep.
I feel like your whip is OP. Like, I feel like you have more range.
Well, you know. You fire a nuclear missile as your special weapon into the map, so come on. Oh, look! He's now a yellowy
oh, god,
guy.
Oh, god.
Oh, and he's throwing stuff now.
See, I think of, like... When I see, like, an old game like this, and I think of, like, okay, they changed the color of that enemy, yeah. I just think of, like, the crimson... was it the crimson enemies in Resident Evil 1?
Nice.
You know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. Like, you leave them there for a while, and mm-hmm. they become just deathly.
Oh, look at that. Broke out of the window. Dynamic environments.
Yeah.
Yeah. There you go.
So, wait. So, okay. So, I'll try to multitask and keep the podcasty vibe going. Yeah. Right, chat? I'm going to try. It's hard. It's hard, okay? I didn't think we'd be doing this.
I think we're going to go into the convenience store now, so I think we get another first-person shoot. Oh, blue! Watch out.
I'm going to do that.
Nice.
Just do it.
Nice.
Cool. But how, like, so if you don't mind me asking, like, how old were you when you were playing this?
Oh! How old am I? That's a good question. Maybe I'm like, I don't know, maybe I'm like 13 or something, maybe?
You're a teenager.
Maybe, yeah. I don't know. It all kind of blur. It's all a bit of a blur. By the way, I do remember though, that this level, when I was playing it, I remember like, okay, I was old enough that I was going around.
Don't kill them!
Oh god! I remember old enough that like my mom would, you know, I'd go shopping with my mom, you know, to Asda or something in England, right? Some big department store,
yeah.
Like shopping mall. And I remember just walking through going, oh my god, just imagine all these bottles blowing up and all this. She's like, why do you have to dream about carnage? And I was like, because that's what the game did. I was just destroying, you know. Where is the fuck? Oh, health.
Oh, yeah, it's good.
Oh, you just stole it from me. You can steal back. That's not hard, is it?
Chat, I'm so sorry. Hey, we did it. We did it. Duel in broad daylight. Oh my god, okay. Since it's like photo, what was it called? Like sensitivity warning, chat. Oh my god, there's like a mayor.
How did you know his job? That's very specific. He's a mayor. He is definitely a bureaucratic official. I can detect a bureaucratic official.
He just looks like one of those like NPCs that would be like in an old Sonic game or something. Like, oh, you seem important. You got a tie.
Yeah.
Like, if you have a tie.
You have a tie. Oh, look at my guy. He just got like an extending arm thing.
There was a guy in like...
Those trash cans. I knew those trash cans.
Oh my gosh. The lady's back.
Blow up. Oh, come on.
Oh, oh my god. You almost got...
Just suck me in there. Oh, game over. Don't die.
Okay. I'm good. I still...
Credit zero?
How do we get credits back?
There's gotta be a... There's gotta be a cheat here. Is that it? I'm out.
Jason's out, chat. Yeah, it's almost like you gotta put a quarter in, but we don't have a way of doing that.
Yeah. I thought it would be tag team as long as one of us stayed alive.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Maybe
like,
the next
one. Like a game we used to know. Yeah. But no. Gosh,
yeah. Yeah, dude. Crazy mechanics.
Yeah, he did steal the life and I died. Yeah, good point.
That's true.
Yeah, good point.
I just see things. I'm playing this like...
I thought you were all about community. You just took the life off me live on air.
They just keep squatting, oh god.
Putting a quarter. If anyone can go and find out how you put a quarter in this emulated version of...
I don't know what to do.
Can we do that?
But I'm like very close to death. I don't have any way to do energy.
You're doing great, man.
I'm trying. Oh god.
I think you can jump and then do a hit as well, I think.
Oh, really?
Can you do like a tap? No?
Yeah, you're right! Whoa! Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. You can do like a tackle!
Yeah.
Dude, it's like... Oh, shoot. Oh, I also like shoot a gun sometimes. I like that. Oh my god! There's no way.
If you get to the end of the level, I can come back in maybe.
That's what I think.
But again, am I projecting a little bit? That's the kind of mechanic we should put in a game.
I wonder if you ever had that idea before.
Yeah.
I can't. I'm dead.
And we're done.
No.
See? Oh, here we go.
Barbarian? Is that good or bad? Wait, you actually won.
I was just happy that I got, yeah, 4 more points.
I literally lost, chat. I lost.
There's no school like the old school.
I actually got slapped. Okay, let's can we pause it for a second?
Absolutely.
That was much harder to talk over than I thought, though.
I know, it's engaging, right?
Yeah.
Look, the eyeball, it's looking at you.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
All right, let me do the thing where it like pulls it out like that. Okay, there we go. That way it doesn't do the preview thing. Yeah. Okay, so do you mind if I go back to full screen?
Yeah, go for it.
Let's do it. I'll just start doing my thing. Okay, so give me context. Like this is teenage years for you, mm-hmm. is this kind of game.
Mm-hmm.
What would like be, okay, because I was telling my chat earlier, we were all talking about it. We were all writing down like childhood games was like the first game we've ever played, like all that sort of thing.
Yep.
What's the like, what is like the game that defined your childhood? And when, like how old were you as well?
Yeah, so I think I mentioned it before, but...
Because this is like the facts I've always wanted to know, chat, and the fact that we can like do this today is so cool.
So yeah, I had the MSX computer. You can program it, you could put mm-hmm. a cartridge in it, load up. It also had a tape drive, so you plugged in a tape player,
yeah.
and you press play, and it would flash load, which was this kind of technique back in the day.
That's sick.
Flash loading, you load up the game. The game I started with, which really blew my mind, was Elite. Right, it was the first game Elite, right? And it was a vector, non-filled vector game, space game.
Yeah.
There's lots of new versions that are very, very good. But that original one, the thing that was amazing about it was the whole game, because the MSX computer, to give you a frame of reference, the memory on board was 64K. 64,000 bytes, right? Well, not technically if you do the calculation, 1024. Anyway, but 64K, but it had so many galaxies and planets and descriptions, and they were all correct. And it turned out a lot of years later, I actually met the programmer who did it and talked to him about it.
Sure.
And the bit of code that made all the planets, all the descriptions of the, because it would say like the planet Lav, and it's got this kind of economy, and it's a democracy, and it has these things, was all repeatable, and it all was just one page of code that we put the data in and made all these planets, all these galaxies. It was incredible.
It's like almost like, it's not like procedural, but it has that vibe.
It was a deterministic system. So this one bit of code with this kind of data set, it would predict, make everything. I remember him saying to me, he was like, yeah, once you got it right, everything was correct. Once one planet was right, everything was then correct.
Is that weirdly, I don't know, we don't have to go down this rabbit hole, but like when I think of like Minecraft or something
mm-hmm.
and how they generate like the world, like, you know, just you put in a different seed code and it always does like, it does like a new thing. Don't play a lot of Minecraft, chat. I'm so sorry. I know y'all want me to at some point, is that similar? Like,
well,
it's more like later when technology gets better and better, then there's things like that, that
well, that's, people can do. Cause then you start talking about like, you start getting into voxels. One of the first things I did to get into the industry, actually, I wrote a voxel polygon engine, which was, I was really into like those games later on, like Comanche Maximum Overkill and things like that, which was voxel landscapes. So you'd have like, you know, these 2.5D pixels. And what you'd do is you'd have a texture map. One of them specified the colors.
Yeah.
And then the other one specified the height of the pixel. And then you'd read it and then you'd basically put it in space. And that's how you made voxel landscapes, right?
Cool.
And some of that technology or some of those ideas, again, I'm not really super familiar with Minecraft in terms of how it's programmed, that idea of having like a texture map that describes a position in space mm-hmm. and then what material is and thing, and then you basically put the brick in, right? And that's how you build up a very complex world very, very quickly.
Look what XS just said.
Oh, there we go.
I have no idea what he's talking about, but I'm here for it.
That's what you get when I'm off message. You get to hear me just going like, ah, blah, blah, blah. But yeah, that whole thing of like what I wanted was a voxel landscape and then polygon kind of craft, casting shadows onto a voxel landscape, which at the time was,
that sounds sick.
It was pretty cool. I used to take that around and go, please look at my demo. I've programmed this. But yeah, that's, I don't know what we're talking about now. But
you know what the game was like a space game.
Oh yeah, Elite. Yeah. So Elite.
It's called Elite?
Elite.
Elite.
E-L-I-T-E.
Super simple.
Elite.
Wow.
Yeah. And it just blew my mind that so much kind of, it was what wasn't shown that switched your imagination on, because there was lots of details and you'd fly to planets mm-hmm. and you'd trade and you'd buy things. Then, you know, you get hit by the Thargons, I think it was, and you'd go into dead space. And when you warp, you'd always warp somewhere It'd be fine, but one out of every 50 warps, you drop into dead space, and there was no stars, and then this huge hexagonal ship would turn up, release all these spawns, and just beat the living shit out of you. And normally it was like, you had all the gold in your car, you're like, not now! Not on this run, I don't want it now! But if you destroyed the mothership, you could collect it, and that thing was worth so much, you'd then go, and run there, and about that time, that's when my mum would come down and go, it's time for dinner, Jason! No! Because there's no saving, there's no pausing. I don't think there's a pause. So
that's so interesting that there was no saving, there was no pausing, and there was like,
I think I'm right in saying that it was, or if it did, I just, it was always just
that's so
upsetting to stop.
That's so interesting. Like I can't, like I know what some of you guys are probably thinking in the chat, like me. It's like when you're talking, the things that you're talking about are things that like I love from your games in the past, where I'm like, that is why I loved it, was because you'd get like on in that role and you'd be like, no, I don't want to turn it off. No,
yeah.
No. And it's like that feeling.
It was like,
and the fact that was like your childhood game was something that evoked feelings like that.
Games were hard. They were hard, right?
Yeah.
There was games like, you know, to go to Activision, you know, Pitfall. That was the first time when I saw it. I was like, wow, this world's so big. I remember my cousin and myself would sit down. We started to draw out every screen, because when you move past the screen, there'd be a new screen. Yeah. So we started drawing on that square paper I was telling you we made sprites with. We started mapping out. We made a whole map of what actually Pitfall was, because it actually made sense. It actually all connected into a dungeon, and there's like a bit where you get a balloon and you'd float up, but you could map it all out. So we just spent every weekend just drawing every single square, everything, and we had it all mapped out. But there's like King's Valley, Populous, all those kind of games.
Are you telling me that you would like draw a spreadsheet?
I draw all the sprites.
Noah J would be so proud, chat. That's so, I'm saying you're like, you would play it and like actually try to map it out.
Yeah. Oh yeah, you had to, yeah. Yeah.
That's so funny.
Oh, you had to if you're a complete nerd like me who just really wanted to obsess about what was kind of going on.
We love the spreadsheets. Oh my God. That's so funny. Those were some of the first.
Like Penguin Adventure. You know, you're a penguin flying into the screen, jumping to get the apple to go and save your girlfriend. You'd have to... It was one of these games where you'd go through the thing, get to the tree, get the apple, and then they made you play all the levels backwards again to come back and bring the apple back to your girlfriend. And you're kind of going along, and you'd slide left and right, and there'd be the holes in the ice, and you jumped over them. But every so often, there was a smaller hole. If you pressed down, you went in, and that was a shop, and you could buy, like, faster boots and things. But you had to... It was just scrolling like this way, right? So it's a little bit like Afterburner and stuff, where you've got like depth, you know, depth.
Yeah, that's sick. Yeah. So Twangy says Penguin Adventure is so fun.
Yeah.
So we do have some people. Yeah. It's great.
Penguin Adventure's great.
Also, oh man, I just had something on the tip of my tongue. I just completely forgot. I was thinking
I don't know, you do this continuous talking thing. I've got to keep drinking. I can't.
Hey, I love this. This is great. You just.
You know me, I spend most of my time just waving my hands around now, trying to.
Yeah. Yeah. But you're like, you're very good. Like, I've always said this before, and I'm going to butter you up for a second. And okay, I won't do this all the time. But you're always really good at. I think I've always said this. I'm like, I feel like you could have been a streamer in another life.
Yeah.
Like if you were born, like maybe when I was born, and no offense, I feel like you would have totally gotten into more of like the content creation, like YouTube, but like you were, instead you influenced what people did with that later.
Here's the thing.
Do you know what I mean?
So I don't know. Here's the thing.
Why?
So,
but you're really good at talking.
Oh, thank you.
I think chat would always agree with that. Like, I've never been like, oh yeah, Jason can't speak well on camera.
You should have seen me when I was a kid. We used to go to, there was a church in my kind of village, kind of town area.
Sure.
I know that sounds really kind of Lord of the Rings kind of. Yeah. I know. I talk about my childhood. It's like kind of like it's the hobbits and so forth. Right? But there was a church and they had like a function hall that was near it. And it's like, yes, it is as you're imagining. It's this old kind of style building with crumbling roof and so forth. And we used to go in there and then do... spoken role playing, right? So, you know, my cousin, who was an aspiring director and writer, became a very, very successful writer, would write these kind of these stories, and then we'd play them and talk, and it was all imagination. You all had to kind of fill it in. And if you could outwit him, if you could, he would respect you and kind of move you along the story. And so it really kind of just fostered that imagination. And again, being kind of up in the north of England where it was raining and it would be quite cold, it really made you dream a lot. You were like,
yeah,
it was really good because the kind of Northern English kind of work ethic's really solid, good kind of worky stuff. But, you know, you're not going out and playing. Like, if I was born in California, I wouldn't have done any of this stuff. So I'd be like, hey, I'm going to go surfing and have fun. But there I was like, okay, I could read books. I could do this stuff. So then getting together and talking was the craft, right?
Is the weather, like, very consistent?
Yeah, it's, I mean, you know, up in North England, you're a little bit, like, a couple of degrees colder than, like, say, London, sure. Right? And you get a lot more rain because the weather system goes under Ireland and drops all the rain in the kind of northwest of England. But that's what made it amazing. So it was...
It almost like it puts you in that situation where you want to dream. Like,
yeah, well, it taught me two things. One was all the people around me, again, Warrington, north of England, was really good work ethic. So people were good, hard, solid workers. You know,
yeah.
in the pubs you'd go into, it was the working man's side and the average pub. And you'd sit there drinking and you'd look over there and there's all these kind of, you know, good kind of solid guys who have, you know, been lugging stuff around, you know. And you'd be on the other side and you go, oh, that's what you turn into as you kind of grow up, right? Mm-hmm. So it did a good work, you know, ethic, but then all the books and all the kind of knowledge was just there to kind of get. So I used to kind of go and live in the library and read all that stuff. And then programming was just a way of expressing and art as well.
And it's a way to like reach things that you can tap into things that you normally, like, I think that's why, like gaming, video games, I mean, now with content creation, all that sort of thing, like, it's just, you can tap into so many worldly things outside of where you normally live at, you know.
But like, when I saw that, when I was doing those things, I was like, I want to be the games master. I want to be.
Yeah,
the,
you
want to. I want to be able to make a story or make a game that people love, fall in love with, want to kind of play.
You want to be the dungeon master.
Yeah, and you know, I didn't have any friends when I was a kid, so I was like, I've made a story, guys. Oh, so no one wants to play it. So I thought, well, if I get into the games industry, they have to play it. I'm just kidding. I was like, I wanted to kind of do stuff that then people would enjoy. People would get into, right? And have those flights of fantasy. That was actually one of the first programming books. There's a book called Flight of Fantasy that taught me how to do... there's a thing called the Bresenham's line drawing algorithm, which is one of the first things I learned to write in assembly language, which is how to do vector lines. So I made a cube, like, turning around. I was like, oh my God! I made 3D! But anyway, that's a tangent. But yeah, that's what really kind of excited me when I was like, I remember thinking, well, when I get to university, that's where I'll get friends and that's where I'll, you know. Yeah. Oh, well.
Well, that was me in university as well. It's like, yeah, like, you know, because your family and everything is like, yeah, like, that's going to be the time. You're going to meet all these people. And granted, I did.
Sure.
But not in the way that they expected.
Yeah. I got to A level. We have in England, we have GCSE, or at my age, it was GCSEs, then A levels, then university. And
so interesting.
You know, at A levels, you know, I was taking, like, you know, physics and maths and computer science and art.
I love how y'all say maths as well.
Yeah, I put an S on it, yeah. I have to say math when I'm talking to American engineers.
Did you ever have, like, this is such a weird tangent. Did you ever have, like, color-coded folders for different subjects? Do you know what I'm talking about?
No.
So, like, when I was in high school, I would have, like, different notebooks for each class, subject.
Right.
And there's always this debate all the time of, like, what color goes with what subject. Because people will be different. Like, everybody's like, I think of math as red. I always associate red with math. I always associate science with green.
Okay, okay.
I'm curious what you think.
Okay, well, I'm going to go off on a tangent here now.
Okay.
And talk about crisps. Chips to Americans.
Okay.
Okay. Cheese and onion is green. And some point in the 90s in England, if there's any Brits on the line, some point in England, cheese and onion became blue. No.
What do you say?
Cheese and onion crisps or chips. Green is the color. It was Walker's crisps. I mean, it's the Walker's chips. So there was a color. And it used to be green. And I've always associated cheese and onion crisps with green. Like, blue was salt and vinegar. Right?
Yeah.
Already salted. Anyway. Tangent. Sour cream onion is green. Cheese and onion.
Oh, so sour, is that the equivalent? Like a sour cream and onion chips?
I don't know. I fell out of I fell out of tracking the crisp world. So I don't know what it's turned into.
Cheese and onion. I've never even heard cheese and onion.
Oh, God.
That's good. Like, I feel like that's a good combo, but there's not like chip. We don't have chips there.
Things
and onion.
I need to bring to the Americans. I need to.
We just had sour cream and onion, right?
Yeah, cheese and onion's great.
Oh, John's in the chat.
John's in the chat. Come on, John. Tell him. Blue salt vinegar. Blue salt and vinegar.
I don't know.
John will remember. Well, maybe John's too young. Maybe I don't know. Sorry, John. Let me educate you. Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
John, I love you're here, man. I love you. I miss you. John, I think I'm going to, like, what? John, aren't I seeing you, like, next year or this year? I feel like I'm seeing you at some point.
You know, you can just ring him up, you know.
We don't operate that way. We always, it's always like, but it's, that's such a good point. We, YouTubers and streamers, like, we're always just like, oh, yeah, just come into my chat and tell me.
Yeah, I'm one of these weird people. I use my phone to phone people.
Ah, that's crazy.
But I'm just showing my age, maybe.
I don't know. I'm curious what people are saying, like, the folder thing. Like, I know, like, some people
say
Mac.
Sorry, I just took your folder thing and turned it into crisps or chips.
I just wanted you to answer, like, the long-lost question of society of, like, what,
no, I was
what a, color goes with
I
what
was
folder.
I was a terrible student. I was... It used to be, I'll tell you this, so we used to have different bands in our school. This is the thing I used to hear when the teacher used to walk in. It was, 7W3, be quiet, get out, Jason. That was the opening sentence that was said, and I remember it now. The teacher used to say to me, 7W3, be quiet, get out, Jason. Because I'd just be talking and be, you know, going on some crazy thing. Like, I remember the science teacher walked in and I said, sir, if we put nuclear bombs all around the equator and fired them at a certain rhythm, could we shift the Earth off its axis and get out and escape the sun? And he was like, that's rubbish, Jason, of course not. And then spent the rest of the lesson working the math out of what it would do. And he was like, now, Jason, it would move the planet Earth like the width of an electron, and then it would come back into its orbit. So it's rubbish. Now, get out. And so we spent the whole lesson. But I got, you know, I got some applause from the class for the fact that I wasted a science class.
Were you kind of like class clown?
No, I was just a bit mischievous. I was just like... Well, because I love playing with the ideas. When I should have been learning... I should have been learning the actual basics, like I told you. But I was too busy going, well, couldn't that just turn into this? Couldn't we do this? What happens if we did change the atomic weights of the periodic table? Would that change the way the world is? Yeah. Of course not, Jace. Well, yeah, I mean, it would.
But
yeah.
3 hours later.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I used to bait teachers to get them off the topic so I could have a nice class that was more interesting and theoretical rather than learning.
That was
rather
my
than eating my
favorite.
Veggies like I should have.
That was my favorite. Like, when you'd have that one guy in class or one girl guy, it doesn't matter. Like, somebody in class, you just know that they're, like, you know when they're, like, baiting. Like, you know when they're, like, hey, like, tell us about your daughter again, or tell us about your, like, son again. And they're like, oh, I would love to. And you're like,
yeah, we really know about
Let's
that.
Go. Let's go. We just wasted 20 minutes. We're good. I was, so, but that, for what's worth, I was.
You're probably studious. You're probably a good student.
I was such a goody two-shoes.
Yeah.
And I made all A's. Humble brag, Chad.
Nice.
I made all A's until college. And then I realized in college that, and again, I got my degree and I still made good grades in college.
Good.
But I didn't do that. Like, I obsessed in high school about making all A's.
Yeah.
And it's because my sister was valedictorian. So I had this, like,
oh, yeah.
You would walk into a class and the teacher that's been there for like 10 years, mm-hmm. No offense to them, they were amazing, mm-hmm. but they would just be like, I remember your sister,
yeah.
Abby. And I'd be like,
I got that as well, yeah.
And I'd be like, oh, man. And then so I just felt like I always had to do better mm-hmm. than what she did.
So
and,
I went the opposite way. I was like, well, I can't achieve those kind of heights, so
yeah.
I'm just going to go the other way.
You're different, yeah.
So my poor parents had to see these report cards that brought up. Like, Jason, what are you doing?
And then I got...
It's like, don't worry, I've got a vision. I know what I'm going to do. I used to... They did these after... You know, we're talking about the careers counselor.
Yeah.
They used to do these aptitude tests where they ask you questions and it would front out and say, oh, you should be a plumber, right? Or something like this, right? But I used to go, I want to be a programmer. So every question you'd ask, it would say, well, you know, what do you like, math or art? I go, well, I like art, but I'll put math down because I know it's going to produce computer programmer as the mm-hmm. result if I keep answering it a certain way. So I just game the systems. Went, look, see, it tells me programmer, not electrician, programmer. It says there, right? Yeah.
Mine was, like, I thought, what's so funny is that when I was going to college, my major was computer science,
mm-hmm.
which is so funny
mm-hmm.
because I ended up getting in the game industry anyways. But like I switched to communications because I doubled down on content creation stuff.
Yep.
But I just remember getting into college and just being like, man, I want to get my degree. I took a marketing minor too.
Right.
But, and I'm very proud of that because I love marketing. Marketing is really fun. But I definitely had that thing where I'm like, man, I don't fit perfectly into this system you're putting in. And going to school at Auburn,
you can imagine, like, when you're in media, all they want you to do and all they imagine you're going to do is you're going to go do sports broadcasting, right? In Atlanta, which is like an hour and a half away, which is like, you know, it's college football, like, area. Like, everybody's about sports. That's what you go intern and do.
I get it. But, you know, they're looking to make sure people have a good career afterwards. Yeah. You know?
Do you know who I, do you know where I interned?
No, where did you intern?
So my last year, I've never told you this. My last year, a couple of years ago.
You're building this up now. I better be like,
so like
NASA.
I had to intern to graduate, but I was like, I was so focused on like my content creation stuff. And I'm like, I don't know if I have time to do content creation, also another job and all this kind of stuff. I actually got approved. I worked for NOAA.
Nice.
And no, so like they're like in, I will never forget for as long as I live that like there's Noah Jay, and he like all the time, we'll be at like a,
does he have to write a report then and send it back to college?
Yes.
Yeah. He was a bit lazy. No, he never got the coffees when I asked him to.
That's the thing. Yeah. It's like, he'll be like, JC, you don't even know what I did for you. He'll be like, we'll go somewhere. And it's like, it's like that peer pressure thing where Noah's like, oh, come on, JC, let's go do this. Come on, JC, let's go, like, come on, let's go hang out tonight. And I'm like, oh, I don't know if I want to. I literally helped you graduate.
The guilt, the thing he has on you now. Yeah, that's fair.
But I just thought that was so, that is like the thing that I'm like, hey, I made it through. But I was still doing classes at the same time. So it was kind of like more of a part-time helping Noah out a little bit. But I was not the best for Noah. I love you, man.
In England, we have to do, it was called work experience. So you're in kind of high school. This is before A-levels, before you go to university. I went to G&I Models. It was a model shop because I was really into Citadel miniatures and Warhammer.
Oh, it's like actually like painting. Sculpting. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, so painting stuff. So I'd sit there and advise on the kind of the paints and the models and on all these kind of things.
Yeah.
Which I loved, right? Because those guys, the model enthusiasts, are just awesome and bonkers. And I used to go get on the train and go to Manchester to Games Workshop. The only Games Workshop was Manchester. Manchester from Warrington as a kid was just like the other end of the world. You know, it was probably a 20-minute train ride or something. But at the time, it was like, this is Manchester, it's the big city. Just so I could get Citadel miniatures, and I could have entered the Golden Demon Awards, which is painting miniatures, and you'd kind of submit them and so forth. It was only later in my career I ended up going to Games Workshop in Nottingham. I did some... It was for Nokia, and I did a Warhammer game. So I ended up going to Nottingham and going around and seeing all the winners of the Golden Demon Awards. And they had a full-scale Uruk-hai warrior from Lord of the Rings in this glass cabinet. It was just incredible. And Minas Tirith was there, like scale model. And I was just like, I'm in nerd heaven.
Dude, I love that. Yeah, I freaking love that. Yeah. Kiva said, did you ever work on a Warhammer game?
Yeah, I did. It was called Glory and Death, and it was an N-Gage game on the Nokia at the time. Yeah.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
What? Kiwi had the facts. Kiwi knew that.
Oh, yeah?
What? I had no idea.
That's some of my darker backstory that we're not going into.
I know you worked on, the one that I always think about all the time, like the surprising game, and Liam always points out all the time, is, like, you worked on one of the Spider-Man games,
yes, right? Spider-Man 3, I think. I came in to help you.
Yeah. That's so cool to know. I love just like those little things where you're
the one that people used to make fun of me with. I can't go into the whole story, but at one point I ended up working at Argonaut Software, which is down in London, which was Jez Sands, who did Star Fox back in the day. This is going old. But Argonaut Software was down in London, and down south. It probably wasn't London now. Everything was London at that age to me. Yeah, it's like, once you go out the north, it was just London. I did the whip for the Catwoman game. I programmed the whip. I was a producer at that time. And so every time anyone would take the piss out of me, it would just go, you know, go and program the whip. And I was like, oh.
It's like one of those things like, oh.
Because it's like, I get so excited, you know how I am, right? I go, look at the whip, I can swing on the wall now, and I was doing all this animation blending stuff.
This game as the robot, you were playing as the whip,
It was the Halle Berry one, which is probably not the pinnacle. Sorry, Halle Berry. But I did a little bit of the whip work for it was like, I don't know, 2 months or something. Went down there. It was an EA game, I think.
Wow.
But
whip gameplay programming. That's
amazing. Yeah. Yeah.
I love the people that still keep coming in there. They go like, what? You're here? I love it. You guys are so funny. Oh my gosh.
I'm bearing my soul here. I'm getting all the skeletons out of my closet. <It's>
No, I love it. We appreciate you for doing that.
No worries.
So, okay. Like where I had stuff written down. I wanted to,
well, we got to do Streets of Rage. At some
we
point.
Do. We should hop back in and then we can come back again.
Enough of the, let's take a break.
I like this. Like, it's like a podcast with chapters of me being schooled on Sega Genesis. Like, it's literally what we're doing.
Okay.
I'm almost done with my computer science. I'm almost done with my computer science bachelor. Is it normal to make my way into different surrounding areas such as marketing or anything else besides programming in the industry? That's a really good question.
What's the question, sorry?
Like, look, this one right here.
Almost done with my computer science BS, yeah, finance and classes. Is it normal to make my way into different surroundings? So based on where your passions are, but programs are great in to kind of, like we were saying before, understand the fundamentals.
Mm-hmm.
You know, once I got in and I've been programming and really enjoyed it, very quickly I realized there was people around me who were really smart and I was like, I loved it. I got my reputation actually, not as an amazing programmer, but as a programmer who was friendly to artists. So there's a lot of translating between. So I'd always take the task like doing AI and stuff. I worked on a Wolverine game once. And the thing I would do would be like, okay, I'm working with the animators to bring the AI to life. And that's what I really enjoyed. Because back in the day, again, this is an olden time. This is not true anymore. If you had a key card, if you're a programmer, it didn't open the artist room. And if you're an artist, it didn't open the program room. It's strange to think now because we have such integrated industry now. But back in the day, programmers and artists did not mix. There was this kind of a little bit of a distant relationship. Yeah. That's not just flat, but it was that little bit of a separation. And so I love kind of bridging that divide because I love talking to the artists, but I wasn't hardcore enough programmer to be a full-on hardcore programmer, but I could get in that middle bit. Well, but that's how you make the fun, right?
You get those connections. You also might find things that you like on that side of things a little bit too, which like I was curious what you were going to say to that question, but I think something I've learned definitely from you for sure is it's really cool when you can wear like multiple hats.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Like that going into like probably any industry, to be honest, but definitely the creative industry. Like if you sort of can be the role that they need you to be in that moment. And then the next day, okay, we need to talk about this. That like, that's just being flexible and having a little bit of that. Like for me, I guess it's like, probably like marketing and design, right? Well, so it's like, it's that sort of mix.
I made the transition really from programming into production. Why? Because I felt that I could help the game more as a producer. Why? Because I could talk to a programmer and understand it, talk to an artist, understand it, and be able to then guide. Because back in the day when I was doing it, production wasn't really even a discipline. You know, a guy he'd be the last one in and the first one out.
Mm-hmm.
When you actually needed production, as the games got more and more complex, you needed people to kind of shepherd it through. But I could talk program, I could talk artist, right? And designer. We didn't really have designers back then. It was mainly programmers who were the designers as well. But, you know, as programmers, we were a bit naughty, right? When a producer would come around and say, okay, so you're going to do a text rasterizer. How many weeks is that? It's about 3 months' work, that. And they go off, you go, I've already done it. It only takes 2 days, right? So in programs being a bit naughty, what I could do is I go, hey, how long is it going to take? About 3 weeks. No, it doesn't.
Right? You would almost like fact check them.
Yeah, because I could talk that thing, right?
Now, that's funny.
So so that was that special power, but that was that need, right? So to answer the question, sorry, it's a long way around.
No, I love it.
When you're going into an industry, you've got like that kind of background, whether it's a computer science background, physics, math, art, whatever you've got. You're looking at what they need and then what your passions are. And that's what I felt. And so being a producer, it also allowed me to come up a little bit and get a wider vision. Because as a programmer or as an artist, you're down here and you need to be. I wanted to start to see games as a whole.
Right.
And then, you know, as my career went further and further along, I wanted to get higher up into the publisher and start understanding marketing and start understanding, okay, well, it's not just about making the game and just throwing it out the door. There's cultivating a tone. There's cultivating a feel. A lot of games is about, I want you to feel a certain way or bring you in a certain world. I felt like I had to go higher and higher to start having a broader perspective of the games being crafted. And then as I came back down as like an EP and doing that kind of work, I could keep going out. But you had to take that hat off because it's very hard to be in and keep going up and down in some of the layers.
Yeah.
But that experience, having a wider vision, grew my appreciation, grew my love of the experts who were programming, doing the art, doing the design. But I had to, you know, if you're going to be captain of the ship, you need to know how the engine works so that then you can walk away and still have understanding when someone comes to you and goes, you know, captain, the engine's breaking. Okay, I understand that now. I understand the severity of it.
Yeah.
And I understand where I'm moving resources to solve problems, because a lot of projects, especially modern projects, they get bigger, 200-man teams, 300-man teams. There's so many things happening. You need to have that as like muscle memory about what the importance of someone coming in going, oh my God, the model's doing this. Yeah, and I go, that's okay. But that's not okay, right?
Yeah, because people might, you know, emotions might be like very high.
Oh, of course, yeah. And tired, people are tired, yeah, and like, working hard and they're passionate.
And then you might be like, oh, that's a bit more hyperbolic than, maybe. You might be able to...
Well, you have the problem of...
And it's also you have sympathy for it too when something goes wrong too.
You have the programmer that's understated, and you can have the programmer that's hyperbolic. You can have the artist that's understated. And so you've got to have an understanding of what things are, otherwise you'll just move to every fire.
Right.
And it's... Dude, so cool. That's really important.
Chat, that is such like, oh, that was the best way to answer that question. So I think to sum it up, just, I think it doesn't hurt. It absolutely does not hurt. In fact, it helps to have more knowledge of some other things outside of the discipline you're in.
Yes.
You know, dabble for sure.
Be a Renaissance person.
Yeah.
Learn science and art. It's good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, you want to check out the next thing?
Oh, yes.
This, I like how we said that this was going to be, like, before we were doing this, we're like, let's just do like an hour. This is definitely over.
Are we over an hour?
Yeah, but it's fine though. Like I it's really chill. Like everybody's being really, really nice in here. So
are we okay really cool. here? Are we okay here? Yeah. Chat, as we say.
Chat, are we good? Are we good?
We okay?
Chat, y'all did not think this was going to happen today. I just love, like.
I'm looking on the wrong screen. I don't know. What's that one?
You can do either or.
Oh, okay.
I have it just for. Simplicity's sake, it's a little bit larger over here. Nice. This is like, that's where I can see like more stats at the top of like this year. So there's like over 200 people in here. And then there's like, yeah, and then this is like donations. And then the same thing. You can even like pull up other chats really fast on here.
Nice.
I don't know. It's cool. It's multitasking like crazy. Anyway. But I gravitated towards Sonic.
You're just like,
please.
So why is this controller keep taking me to Sonic? I remember that. I remember going to Pyramid Micros in my town center as a kid and just walking in. And as I walked in, I heard it. It was like you could have dropped the color in the scene and just had the kind of bright monitor of a CRT glowing and just went, Sega. And I went, oh, how did they do that? Because like the sound chip programming, like to do that, to get it to say something was just incredible.
Yeah.
And I remember walking up and it's like, ah. I remember it being like a religious experience for me as I heard Sega. Because I was like, wow. I remember like, yeah, Nemesis like 2 or something. At the end, the boss guy goes, ah, ha, 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 and I went, how did the program, how did you get the sound chip to make a voice? That's incredible.
So when I was playing Vector Man at the start of the stream, when he dies, he screams in agony.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just like, and he was saying voice lines that were really well done. Like, so could you do voice lines on the Genesis?
By the Genesis. Like, you could. But it was just like at the very beginning of it.
Why didn't Sonic have voice lines then?
Because I'm sure this programmer's out there could tell me about it, but I remember it was above my programming skill at the time, and I was like, wow. I mean, I do things like popcorn. I used to program all the notes into the old MX computer. And you'd sit there for days programming in each note and telling the sound chip to do the thing. And then if you got one of them wrong, you go,
Sonic Speeds and Sonic CD. That's like a couple, that's on the...
Yeah, it's a little bit later.
CD was on the Saturn, right?
Well, there was the Mega CD as well, right?
That's probably Sonic CD then.
Is that Sonic CD?
Yeah.
I probably remember a different name.
Because I think, chat, Mega CD is, wait, that's different. Is that different from the Saturn?
Because there was
my brain.
Yeah, oh no, yeah, Saturn's way later. Way Saturn's later. Yeah, no, there's Mega CD. Wasn't there? Oh, God.
So
going back, I'm realizing that all the drugs and alcohol have... turn my brain into Swiss cheese at this point. Sorry. I get the feeling there's someone out there going, Jason's so wrong on these things. I apologize.
Dude, for me, and I've always told you this, Sonic Adventure, we need to play the game, but Sonic Adventure, we need to play...
Let's play a game. We come to Sonic. Let's talk about how much we love Sonic. Okay, let's talk about how much we love
Sonic. But Sonic Adventure, that was my first video game ever. Uh-huh. And so, like... That's like 3D. They're competing against Mario 64 probably at that point.
Did you have any arcade experience? Did you ever do arcades?
You ever play Metal Slug?
Oh, yeah.
Played that. I would go to the pizza place and play that.
The Neo Geo. Remember the Neo Geo?
No.
Only the rich kids had those. They would like, and I mean that by the way, as in the machine was like, I can't remember how many it was, but it was some pounds, right? But it might have been like, I don't know, 100 quid, 100 pounds, something. But the cartridges were like 500 pounds. Like the all the tech was in the cartridge. And so you could never have I could never afford a Neo Geo. I had £10 from paper money. I used to deliver papers in the morning on my bicycle. Like Paperboy, the old game. And I used to deliver, and I get £10, and that was what I could spend on computer games. So
what? So I had quarters. I'd go in and play Metal Slug at
yes, some Neo Geo did only have like 3 good games, but they were amazing. Oh yeah, Metal Slug. No, but the arcade was a whole culture. You go to the arcade.
Yeah.
And that was like nothing like you could have at home. It was just incredible.
Yeah, see, I feel like I missed that.
Oh, it's mad.
I feel like I missed that. Like when I grew up, like I was right before, I was a couple years before online gaming really started hitting.
Mm-hmm.
So I had like a little bit of like playing some stuff by myself in my home, but there wasn't like an arcade nearby where like we all went.
It was like Outrun. You could sit down, you had a bit of wheel. Or you play it on Afterburner, you had to do the double tap on the thing to do the spin.
No, Afterburner, I've just never...
Oh, yeah.
Man.
So Rampage. Oh, my God. Two-player Rampage. Beating the crap out of buildings. The original.
Twenty says, do you have any...
Midway. That was Midway games, I think.
Do you have any funny stories about Parappa?
Yes. That's for another stream.
Jason After Dark. Oh, man.
Yeah.
All right, let's...
Okay, Streets of Rage.
Streets of Rage?
We got to go with the original, right? The OG, Streets of Rage.
Which one's better?
I'm going to say the original.
Really? Are they all two-player?
I think so.
Okay, let's see.
It's been a minute.
Let's see. Time to watch Jason kick the hell out of JC.
Two is better. People are like, no, what is he talking about? This is the one I played. I don't know if I had the second one. I'm not sure.
The city was once a happy, peaceful place.
Until one day, a powerful secret criminal organization took over. This vicious syndicate soon had control of the government and even the police force. The city has become a center of violence and crime where no one is safe. Amid this turmoil, a group of determined young police officers have sworn to clean up the city. Among them are Adam Hunter, Axel Stone, and Blaze Fielding. They are willing to risk anything, even their lives, on the
streets
of Rage.
Wow.
Wow. Power. Wow.
I love Adam Hunter.
Yeah, these are great names.
Oh, I missed that, whatever that was.
Sorry. Okay, here we go.
There we go. We're going to have to...
Okay, who are you going to be?
I want to be Blaze.
You need Blaze? Okay, you be Blaze. I'll be Axel.
Chat's gonna make fun of me.
Axel, is it A? Or start? It's like...
I think it might be start.
Yeah. What? It's the cat. The cat's at the door.
I hope. Can I?
Yeah, go on.
Hey.
This is where I'll get ahead while he's not here.
Both cats are underneath the door, like just peering in. They're just like, what are y'all doing in there?
USA versus Great Britain, make us proud, JC. Okay.
I'll try my best. I'll put the headphones on.
I see this more as, rather than countries, more old school versus new school.
Yeah, that's more like it. It's like, you know, like they'd always do on like Survivor and stuff, like all the different... See, I used to watch Survivor all the time as a kid.
Okay.
What? Why did you never?
No.
No? Dude, but they always do the thing like David and Goliath and all these different like things. And I think they had an old school versus new school thing, I think.
Oh. Wow, the police really have taken things seriously recently, haven't they?
He has a death machine.
Did you press them? Oh, pressed the, that's the special move. That was Yeah.
No, I didn't. I didn't do anything.
Then maybe it was me then.
Oh, wait, okay, so... Whoa. That's,
that was me. So circle is special move. Which, again, we just... we just wasted... Why do we do this every time? We just... We special... We fire all the special moves.
Let me, like... Let me reload it. Let me reload it. let me reload it and just, like, let's look at the controls.
Oh, instructions are for...
It'll load really fast, hopefully. Hopefully it can load fast.
Yeah. I do miss... We need to take the car...
Yeah.
Put it back in.
Okay, let's see.
But does it map, like, what's A and B on... We have no clue.
A, B, and C. So, okay, so...
So, X... specialty move is definitely circle. Because I pressed it a bunch of times and made bad things happen.
You're right.
So, I'm thinking it's X and square, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let's just not press circle and press every other button and we should be okay.
This has to be fight. That has to be, like yeah. X has to be...
Well, that was the punch for my character.
Yeah, okay, okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're gonna figure it out. Chat, this is, you know, we're doing it live. That's how things are.
Okay.
All right, I'm going, boys.
I'm ready. Ready.
Chat, how's the audio? Good? Should be good. Y'all can hear it a little bit. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, you can use, ooh.
Okay. Oh,
does it what do did you press? I didn't press anything.
Okay, I pressed square. So square might be the special
thing. Okay. And it's that at the top? Yeah. The S?
Yeah, so I pressed square. So maybe circle's okay then.
Okay.
Yes, circle's jump for me.
Ooh, okay, okay.
Okay, so jump. And, oh, there's a jumping knee.
Hey, hey, hey. Oh my god. Hey, hey. Oh wait, I can fight you.
It's on. Oh shit. That's how we're playing it, is it?
Wait, where do I go?
That's triangle. Oh, come on.
A jump attack.
Jump.
No, no, I'm over here. I keep thinking that's like energy from the last game. Jesus!
Let's work together.
Okay, okay. That's really cool. You can fight each other. He's off screen.
Yeah, we're off. We're ready.
Chad said,
we have all the skills we need.
Chad said, kick his ass. Jesus.
Hey.
Oh, I got this kind of left.
Oh, this reminds me, like, again, the Konami Turtles game was in the arcades. Oh, that was amazing. Okay.
She did, like, she flipped off of the enemy.
Oh, did she? A bit of a...
Like, she, like, jumped off.
There's no run. Have you found a run?
I don't think so. Maybe they had that in the sequel.
Yeah, maybe.
Hey, I tried! Oh, my God! What?
I don't know how I grabbed you, but there we go.
What? I am literally like just jumping away.
Oh, it's a backwards hit.
We get Jason on stream one time, chat, and he's trying to suplex me into the ground.
Okay.
Oh, nice. There you go. Okay.
There you go. Right, it's both buttons. It's X and circle does something.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh,
look at that.
Oh,
that
shoot.
Was pretty incredible.
So I have a kick, I think.
Yeah, so both those is a reverse.
Oh.
Oh, oops. Being too.
Ooh. Whoa, he just slid.
I keep looking for a run, but or a block. Do you have a block yet?
Yeah, maybe it's. Oh, that's speed up the level. I can rewind the level. Wait.
No, we can't be like that.
You see that?
Yeah, no, we can't.
That's cheating.
We can't do that.
Okay. Take it! I didn't even notice. I was like, oh, get the apple.
Okay, the apple. There's gonna be a pipe somewhere. There's always a pipe.
Maybe it's in the trash can? I go this way.
Or a bottle.
Oh my god. Oh Jesus Christ. No! Whoa! Whoa! I just grappled off of you. You see that?
Is it wrong for me to want to...
Don't do this, Jason! This looks very bad!
Ah, don't do... Oh, I lost the bottle. Don't get to use the bottle.
Oh my god.
Okay. Sorry, I'm probably messing all the levels up on the mic by shouting so much.
No, it's fine. Okay. We got some... Jason, if there's one thing you should know about me, is that I am, like, so specific about audio that it will be, like I will, like my chat will always attest to this. Like when Emmy streams, she like her audio will be there's all crazy, and I'll be like, no.
"Here we go!"
Oh Jesus! Oh no!
Oh God! Oh God!
I didn't have this on my. I didn't have this on my bucket list. Oh, no, that's not the right
thing. The pipe's working for me.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. Oh, I can do so many like grapple attacks with her, which is sick.
God, he's running back at me. Why can he run? I can't run yet.
All right, I'm gonna do a special attack because I just want to know what happens.
The police coming.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. They're just not messing around with unreasonable force, the police force these days. Okay.
It's kind of cool that a lot of...
Oh, he's got a baseball bat.
Oh, my God. A lot of the games that we're playing on here have that sort of special move ability.
Yes.
Like, I wonder if they all were, like, influenced by each other
at
the time.
That was the thing.
Not that games don't have special moves anymore. They all pretty much still do, but it's... Oh!
What?
What was that?
I broke out. You're about to jump over me and do, like...
I just caressed your head. I was just holding your head.
It's getting a bit...
Wow, jeez. I have like no health compared to you. You have so much more.
Well, I've been keeping picking up the apples. I think I've been stealing the apples. Oh, there's a martial artist.
Oh jeez. I'm just gonna keep jumping.
Oh my god. He reminds me of Yi Yao Kung Fu on the Konami again. Yi Yao Kung Fu too.
I've never heard of
that. Sorry, these things are just gonna stop me.
No, keep going. I love it. This is the goal for today is go retro. Oh! Oh!
There we go.
Let me see if I can grab this guy. Oh! I just screamed in agony. Okay, I'm back. I lost one life, but that's fine.
I feel we have to do this style praying. Because you got to do...
Oh, like
because there's two for the reverse punch.
Well, like the claw?
Yeah, the claw for doing reverse punch. Hey, I...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because I don't think... You're not using triangle, right?
No. Oh my God, who is she?
What's she all about? Can we get that whip?
Every game that we've played has a whip.
I know. Oh, there's a knife.
Oh. Oh! Whoa! Dude, I almost just
forgot
got...
I forgot that you could beat each other. I keep stealing all the food from him. But after the Alien Storm life moment.
Yeah.
She still got the whip. Oh, there's another one.
Yeah, it's multiple.
How do you grab for a...
Oh! I like threw her off screen.
That's the way.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. See you in the next one.
Don't get to the edge. That's where the bad things come.
Oh!
Uh-oh.
Oh my God. Okay, I guess the only way you can dodge it is by looking at the shadow? I don't know. Okay, I got this guy a little bit. Dude, Jason is killing it at this game. Like, I can't...
Get my vibe back, man.
Like, I am getting destroyed. I've lost another life. How are you still alive?
Because I keep taking... You keep taking the ham. I keep picking up the ham.
Okay, there we go. That's gotta be it.
Suplex.
Oh. What?
You press square.
Did I accidentally press it?
That's okay.
Fine, we'll take it.
Take it.
That'll end it.
Boom.
I thought they'd like make
like
you watch.
They say, there's no point saving the monkey bum if you don't make it to the next round.
That's true. That's true. You gotta... I am the ultimate person with that. I will... All of the things that I will be given in a game,
mm-hmm.
and I'll be like, oh, I'll save it. And then it'll be like the end of the game, and I'll be like, oh, I didn't use any of that.
I should have used that. Streets of Rage. These are dark streets, and we are cleaning them up.
Oh yeah.
Oh. See, when I look at that, I look at like the number of colors in that sprite. Oh, look at that.
It's so funny as well.
That was a big transition for the industry as well. You know, we went from 2D to 3D.
Yeah.
There was a whole change in the guard. I mean, as I was coming in, there was people who dropped out because 3D was just a different type of work.
It was like scary.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, we're gonna see some of that with AI and other things going on these days. But there's transitions when industry goes through different techniques and things are learned.
Yeah.
you know, again, making a game back in these days to making 3D and different types of things. Well, it's like changed it's like the mentality and the techniques that have to be used.
All the like, there's so many games now that use like procedural systems and everything like that. Like, I can't imagine like the.
But there's a methodology difference. Like, as soon as you go to 3D, you have to, as a developer, there's just a different way of thinking about it and how.
Yeah.
You know, and then you got to work out how to express yourself in that medium, right?
Yeah.
Oh, headbutt.
Dude, it's so hard. Like, I was fully expecting, like, as...
So
anyways, let me ask you more about your childhood, Jason.
Knife.
Oh, God. I'm just such a, like, an evader in games. Like, I love just jumping and dodging.
I'm gonna grab you, and I'm gonna do that, then do that.
Send him off stream.
I've learned the keys. Keys to the buttons.
Let's go. This is all one level. Oh,
trash can.
Oh, that's like
bottle,
a
bottle.
No, that's a. Oh, it's a bottle.
God dang it!
Oh, wait, let me grab this
what
apple.
The hell is
I need that? The apple. All right, I got the apple. We're good. We're good. Okay, there's a knife.
You gotta throw the knife. Stop it!
Oh, that was a combo move.
You landed. That was a combo move. You can pick and throw each other to attack.
What?
So we could be all.
Oh, I'm trapped.
Doing acrobatics.
Wait, so can I? Can I like?
I want to throw the knife at someone and get him. There we go.
Oh! What is that? What was that?
Hit the whip
is that
lady.
A life?
Hit
that's gotta be a life.
Yeah, hit the whip lady with the bottle.
That's a life. Okay. Oh my gosh.
Nice.
I wanna get the,
I'm getting there. It's all coming back.
I wanna see if I can throw you and, like, do something. Like, can I? So I can-
That's a move, yeah.
I can- So if I only press grapple-
Grab me and then throw.
I can, it just throw it. Ooh.
That's nice.
Can you do that to me? Or you only use the grapple?
What's the grapple?
I think it's just the jump. Like, yeah.
Nice.
Oh, you do like a...
Shoulder charge. Kind of
yeah,
shoulder
like a shoulder thing.
Yeah. Right, you're getting a knife in the back.
Wait, I thought that was an enemy. I got so distracted. I did not mean to do that.
I'm enraged now.
Ah! Wait.
Oh! You see that?
No! Now I'm very much realizing why. This is why friendly fire was never a thing in some of the games that you made.
What are you talking about?
I guarantee you.
I'm really rethinking some of the decisions of my past now playing this character.
Yeah, like, oh my god, man.
The edge of the screen's danger.
I'm just getting beat up. Boom! I wanna grapple. I want to do it to an end. Oh wait, here we go. No, I'm like I have to be right on the same.
Don't get in the way of the fury, man.
Oh, that guy's gone. Oh, we're good. Hey. Oh. Would this be a game at like an arcade?
Yeah,
it is.
I mean, I don't remember playing it in the arcade, but I'm sure it was. But
like some version of it or something.
Yeah, I mean, what was the other one? It's Double Dragon on the Master System.
Whoa!
Before the Mega Drive. Which is a very similar idea, right?
Yeah.
Remember Double Dragon, right?
You know? I've heard of it, but I've never played.
Oh, wow, he's like a boss guy.
I don't think you realize like how much my life as a kid was consumed by Sonic the Hedgehog.
Oh, no, I think I did.
Like, so much of my life. Like, I would get like a Game Boy or something, and I would still just play Sonic games. On Game Boy.
Oh. Oh, come on.
I love that they have all this stuff on PS5 though.
Yeah, awesome.
Like, I did not realize that you could play classics. It's really cool on the PS5 controller too.
Yep. Yeah! Oh!
Dude, I'm like,
I wanted to hit someone with that jumping.
I want to get it too, but I, like it's really
evil,
hard to.
It's like an evil clown guy.
Yeah, he does. He's got like Joker vibes.
Yep.
Oh. Oh, if I was just right, like I need to be a
ham. who's in this deadly city? Who is hiding chunks of ham under trash cans or oil barrels? Who is this menace?
Oh, I got
suplex the clown. Is that a suplex? I don't know.
What's your like when you're playing a game like this?
Yeah.
And you are, let's just say, vibing mm-hmm. in your teenage years.
Mm-hmm.
What's like go-to like snack of choice?
Well, there's an old. I'm using English words now, British words now. So there's old crisps called Space Invaders that were pretty awesome, and Twirly Whirlies.
Not the game Space Invaders.
No, though. The crisp Space or the chips.
How did they have the rights?
It was like Monster Munch. You know Monster Munch?
No.
There's Monster Munch.
Did the way I had the knife like that? Oh my god!
Oh, okay, hold on. Oh, this is getting intense.
Whoa! Like, Wolverine just showed up. Okay.
And then you used to also get, like, what's called tempe mix-ups back in England, which is, like, a little bag, and they put 10 pence worth of sweets, which is a lot.
Really?
God, I'm sounding old now. I don't want to do this anymore. I'm Amanda, we had sweets, and there was...
Chat's like, what the F is a Twirly Whirly?
What's a Twirly Whirly? You got the internet. Come on. Twirly Whirly. Where's John when we need him? Surely John should be saving us.
I don't know if John's still here. I'm not sure.
Oh, okay.
He probably is. No, John is 100% lurky. There's no shot he's missing this stream. There's no shot. When you say Twirly Whirly, I just think of like a... No, was like the little vines.
Like no, it's like vines. It's like a chocolate caramel thing that kind of twirl, and it was in like a paper wrapper.
What?
Yeah. Like when I first had Snickers, you know Snickers bar?
Yeah.
They were called Marathon in England.
Marathon?
And they were rebranded to Snickers. But what? They were for like the longest time they were called Marathon bars. And so, I'd get up at 4 a.m. and walk 3 hours to the mine and yeah.
No. Did you okay, what about like so the reason why I ask is like I have like an image in my head, right?
Mm-hmm.
I have an image of like what my dad used to like bring me when I was playing games.
Oh, yeah?
All the time. I had a very cool dad. I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, got it.
When I was younger. Awesome. Dad Fire's still around, chat. But I'm just saying, like, as a kid, like I was just really lucky because he would just let me play a lot of things and nice. Play games that you made that I probably shouldn't have been playing at the age I was.
Respect the ESRB ratings, kids.
Wait, what?
Respect the ESRB ratings.
Yeah, respect the ESRB ratings.
Yes.
But also, I'm glad I did. This one is. But, oh, cool. But the thing for me was always I would get home from school.
Mm-hmm.
We were big on sweet tea. Nice. So bad for you. But nice. we would have jugs of sweet tea. And that was like the thing. I would have a glass of sweet tea. Oh, we got the beach.
You got some California vibe.
Probably. Yeah.
Yep.
I would have a jug of sweet tea, and he would make me homemade cookies a lot.
Oh man, that's good.
Which normally is like a grandmother thing, but Deadfire would just do that. He would do that all the time. Awesome. And there it is. There's the Deadfire emotes in the chat. That's one of those things that like I have to get that to happen someday. Is you meeting him?
Oh, absolutely.
Because like. That would just be such an insane moment for me. Like, y'all definitely talked to each other before, like on the phone or something,
yeah, yeah.
But not like, not
well, person. I think last time it was always like, I was doing something or coming up to see you or something, so
yeah.
Very brief. I normally have a bunch of PR people around me or something.
Yeah, like. And they're like, who's Deadfire? who's this guy?
I think we're doing well.
What is it? Like, I keep thinking that that's an object.
I know. Bad design there.
Bad design.
We'll get it right to them on that one. That's,
let me hold you.
I'm confusing the environment with interactable props. Come on.
It
needs to pop a bit, guys. I feel like I'm ready to talk to the guys. The designers, this thing's blending into the background a bit too much.
It's just the trash on the beach.
Yep. Some background artists got a bit too enthusiastic.
Yeah, they're like, this actually, you know, a bit of Santa Monica a few times. that was cool!
I should have helped. I was holding you and then you were just kicking, right?
Yeah, that was like, whoa, money? I just found money.
Nice.
My god, we have the same pose. me and the girl had the same pose on the ground, like when we were both like dead.
good old 1990s game design, yeah. Dad firing the guitar, yeah. Do you play instruments?
Yeah.
Really?
I did a music GCSE, yeah.
What?
Yeah, back in school. A bit of guitar, a bit of music theory, did they have music theory? What? I actually, yeah. I'll stop there.
What?
Yeah. Again, you know, get a broad knowledge of things, right? That's
good. What's like go-to instrument? Is that guitar?
Yeah.
You know how to play the guitar and never met my dad?
Yeah.
That's like his thing.
But if you want to, like, again, music theory, if you want to get behind it, you need to learn the piano. Because I was learning kind of tablature and, you know, how to read music, read music and stuff. And again, a lot of engineers or programmers, that kind of mindset for music is the same thing.
Yeah.
It's like, it's in the same kind of world.
That makes sense.
Which is why the art side is then good as well, because there's the science of understanding resonance and chords and how that works. And then there's the art side about what you're actually doing, right?
Mm-hmm.
So when you first play an instrument, you're playing the instrument, and then later you're playing the music, right? But you've got to learn to play the instrument first, and then you play the music second.
Yeah, right? That makes sense. The nice turkey platter right yeah. on the ground.
Is that turkey or ham? I'm saying ham, but yeah.
Oh, I think turkey.
Is it turkey?
That's very American of me to say that. It's like Thanksgiving and everything.
It could be.
Oh, I think I just died. It's telling me to input my name.
There you go. You're going to go in there. So I used to, so when I was growing up, there was, game magazines. And the magazine I used to read all the time was called Mean Machine. And there was a guy in there called Jazz Rignall. And I thought that was the most amazing name. And every time he'd do a review, he'd change his character, the character in the review to whatever game he was playing. So if it was a Formula One game, he'd have a racing helmet on. But Jazz Rignall, I was like, Jazz Rignall. In arcade games, you could only put three letters in as your name. So all the arcade machines I used to get high scores on was always Jazz. I used to write Jazz in as my name into all the arcade machines in my hometown.
That's cool. It's a little fun little fact.
Yeah.
You like Jazz.
Yeah. Well, he ended up doing reviews on a thing called Games Master, which was a show on British TV.
Yeah.
So I then finally started to see him. I was like, oh, there he is. There's the guy. But I was, I stole the idea of Jazz, J-A-Z, N-Z, for arcade machines for three letters. Nope. Sorry.
That's okay. I've been
You've been
I've been beaten to death multiple times today.
It's close.
I tried, chat. I tried for the Twitch clip. I couldn't get it. I tried, guys. I really tried.
Am I done?
So I pressed, put in my name and then it said I could hit continue.
I'm gonna do it.
Oh, look at that rain effect.
I'm gonna do it. I've not done this. How do I go to the next character?
I press start. Or I guess for us it's not start.
How do you go to the next character then?
I wasn't sure.
There it is. Oh. I'm doing it now. My god, this is this is now kind of going back, so there we go. Continue.
We have to do a stream one day of my 3D retro games. You'll be like, yeah, retro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we should do this and play your generation of games. Yeah.
Yeah. Because this is a little, this is just, oh, I keep doing that. Keep going in for a little kiss.
Yeah.
Hey. Yo, kiss. Chat, no. No. This is like my generation of games, Chris. Yeah. Dude, it's cool, for sure. I also think, weirdly enough though, Jason, there's a lot of games nowadays that are like going back to simplistic styles like this for a little bit of that nostalgia, for a little bit of let's play something more simple.
These games were building on ideas and looking at stuff, right? And there's lessons to be learned in here. I know I sound like the old guy.
Yeah.
You know, but like, they got to...
like that.
Well, I'm bringing the police in on that one. But you know, they learned things. There was things in those old games. And you can say, it's not relevant. It's like, it totally is.
Yeah.
You can transpose these ideas into new ideas.
There's design decisions somewhere that are in here that still hold up to this day.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to call in the RPG. Because these guys are insane.
Yeah, they're pretty bad.
Yeah, Metroidvania is really big right now. Yeah, for sure. For sure.
Absolutely.
Yeah, like the new...
Looks like WWF or WWE's now.
It does, it does.
Yeah.
It really does.
Because now that's the... Isn't that the World Wildlife Foundation? So they changed it to WWE, didn't they?
I think... Is that why?
Yeah, when I was a kid, it was WWF. And then they changed the WWE, and I thought it was because WWF was the World Wildlife Foundation. That's why they did the panda bear with like a chair. I think so. as the joke, right?
I didn't know that.
I don't know.
Yeah, the chat's saying you're right.
Am I right?
Yeah. Oh, man.
In the playground at school, you know, we'd be doing like Boston crabs on each other or like trying to do suplexes. I used to have a friend at school who go, Jay, let me just try this move on you. It won't hurt. And then he put me in and go, ah! I go, ah! Yeah, there's a lot of... WWF recreations school.
I want to look at my notes really fast because I had stuff written down I wanted to ask you, but I feel like we've covered so much.
Yeah.
Okay. I. This is good. So help me picture this, right?
Okay.
So you're playing games like this. You know, I already did like the whole like, all right, what's the food? You said the twirly whirly is one of them.
Oh man. Oh yeah.
Which I'm like, what?
Space Invaders is good. Yeah.
But I was wondering, okay, taking a step back from games, but it's all kind of like maybe around the same time.
Mm-hmm.
When you're growing up and maybe things that influence you, I don't know, but what's like what's like cartoons? Like, what are like the cartoons that you watch? Like, what are the things that you watch?
Okay, now here we go. let's start.
Asking, like, chat, this is like such a... this never happens, right? Like I forgive me, chat, for asking very like, what's your favorite show? But like, I just, we've never known a lot of these things sometimes. And like, you never really have had the chance to be like, cause you're always doing like a marketing thing.
Sure.
When you're like on a stream and just being able to like, just chill and hang out. It's like, okay, we can talk about literally whatever. And I'm just like, okay, what'd you watch on TV? Like,
okay. First off, so an animation house. It was in Manchester again, so
I can go full screen really fast.
And it was Danger Mouse, and it was Cosgrove Hall. Cosgrove and Hall, the two guys. Danger Mouse, Count Duckula, were the kind of two kind of cartoons that I just religiously loved. Then there was the Cities of Gold. Cities of Gold, which please look up. And that went on forever. That just went on forever. And so I just watched it. It was a story that just
Chris and Chad
went on forever. And I'd have to go home every day to watch the City of Gold. Please let them find the City of Gold. Like, when will this stop? Just to let you guys know, I've suffered a very long story as well.
Wow!
City of Gold. So Danger Mouse was episodic. City of Gold was the longest thing that ever went on.
Wow.
What else was there? Cartoons. I'm trying to think.
The things that we all know, we don't have to say it. We all know. That's
cartoons.
So funny.
What else? Cartoons. I'm gonna get off here and then go. Oh, that one.
Did you like? Were there comic book cartoons at the time or no?
Well, I was so.
I'm trying to think of like when.
I mean, like you'd have like Garfield and stuff, like this little animated Garfield thing.
Well, there wasn't the show actually. No, Was there superhero stuff?
Well, Spider-Man and His Amazing Friends. Yeah.
That, okay.
And that was late 70s, early 80s. So
for me, it was like I watched like Teen Titans on Cartoon Network.
Okay.
Like the OG Teen Titans. Not like the rebooted one. Like I haven't seen the rebooted one too much because I just grew up with these.
Oh, Marshall Bravestar. Marshall Bravestar.
No idea what that is.
Speed of a Puma. You turn it. You get like, you'd summon these powers and then do things. Obviously, Thundercats. You had to do Thundercats. And what else do we have? Oh my God. He-Man. You had to do He-Man.
Yeah.
Right.
Did you watch Transformers?
Oh, yeah. Oh, God, yeah.
Oh, heck, yeah.
Yeah. I wasn't a G.I. Joe guy. I missed that. We were friends who were. I wasn't.
Yeah.
But He-Man, big-time Transformers. That was like every, you know, hey, Jay, what would you like for Christmas this year? Gotta get a Dinobot.
They did that, I think, in the...
And then some kid would come in with, like, Optimus Prime, and he's like, no, never Optimus Prime, never got. I got the snow base though. I got the Star Wars snow base from Empire Strikes Back, which was amazing. And you had like a little thing you press. You put Han Solo and press the button, and it'd throw him off. And there's another button you could blow up the base, so you could bring your AT-AT in. Press the button, and the base would blow up.
Yeah. See, I was like, I feel like I didn't watch as many cartoons as a lot of people here. I guess like, and also, anime wasn't as big in the West back then, well, right?
I was part of the I was part of the UK manga club, which was like you wrote off and got a letter, and they would send you like newsletters about manga stuff. But it was like there wasn't that many of us.
No shot.
So I thought I'll tell you this. This is funny. I thought that when I grew up, I would be living in Japan because in my mind, the games industry was Japan.
Right.
Right. And then Wolfenstein came along and those games came along. And I was like, oh, America's doing games as well. But I was all, because I was doing Konami and everything, I was all Japanese focused. So I started learning Japanese and I was like, right, I'm ready.
Oh, wow.
I'm ready to go to Japan when I get old enough because that's where I'll be a programmer. That's where the games industry is. And Britsoft was really big, but I was like, I want to go to where I'm the games that I'm playing. So yeah. I was like, I'm going to go to Japan.
I'm sure you've been to Japan a couple times now.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. But at the time, I was just like, that's where I'm going to end up. Like, that's what I've got to get ready for.
There's a lot of, like, I know Noah just went recently to visit for his first time, and mm-hmm. he was just like, it's so great.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
It's very cool. I got to go. I still have not gone.
Oh, man.
And
it's so cool.
It hurts me inside. Like, I want to go there so bad. I have not, Chad. I know. Oh, my gosh. I wonder if you... Can you speak any Japanese at all?
Yes, but I would embarrass myself and I don't want that to be recorded, so no.
Sure.
I know like a couple of words, and there's people I know who might watch this and I say, yes, I'm not going to try it.
Yeah, that's understandable.
Yes.
But that's cool that you like you've tried to learn it before.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You probably know more than I think you're like letting on. Maybe?
No.
Okay. Satchel said I saw this in the chat earlier, so I want to bring this up. Like Satchel was saying, Jason, I know it's a big question, but what are your like some of your favorite games of all time? Maybe not retro, maybe could be retro, probably be some a lot of retro stuff, but like when you go to maybe less like what started your video game journey, because we kind of got into that a little bit.
Sure.
Said, like Elite sounded really cool. I want to look that up.
Oh yeah.
Sounded really sick. But what's something that stands out as like, I don't know what era of your life it would be, but it could be modern too.
You know what? It was the games that just let your imagination run wild. So there's games like that, and there's games that took you into a world. That was always and still is probably a driving force for what I do, which is
sure.
You know, can I give you a world? Can I get you into a place where it's fully realized? It's been thought through. Everything has this makes sense, even if it's crazy and you don't understand it. There's a meticulous like nature to how that is.
Yeah, it's like the
but it lets you dream beyond, right? It lets you want a world where you can dream about different angles. Like there's certain stories and games where this is the story and this is the world, and it's a bit hard to kind of think further. You want to be able to leave open routes, and so that's what those games always did that for me, which was, you know, this one didn't, but you know, yeah. I could look at this, a certain game like this, if you did certain things, you go, I wonder what is outside of there. I wonder where those characters came from. I wonder, you know, those games used to really kind of get me. And so it's really weird. I'd have to think about that some more. I'll think about that. But
it's,
yeah,
it's like you like games that have like a weight to the world in a way, right?
Yeah,
there's a bit of more, there's more texture, there's more...
I know there's a creator somewhere, and I want to play with him. I want to be, or her, I want to be in there going, I got a great idea, I can see what you're doing mm-hmm. here, but there's space for it. You've not closed everything down, right?
Yeah.
You have a distinct vision that you're doing, and I want to be able to have fun with you, right? And that's what I'd like to give to, you know, when I make games, is like, how can I get everyone in there and you can all be having fun? Right,
yeah.
Enjoying yourself and letting your imagination run wild, right?
I definitely think you've been successful doing that. Just a little bit.
Thank you, man.
A little bit.
Yeah,
I will say that for Chad.
You gotta strive for it. You gotta strive for it. It's tricky, right? But you know as well, because you can feel the excitement. Like there's a point in time in certain games where you can't type fast enough. You can't get it out fast enough, because once you get it and you're suddenly like, oh, you just want to keep going.
Yeah.
So yeah, games like that let me come in, let me imagine in their world. And again, it goes back to the role playing and all that kind of stuff, and the painting of figures and miniatures. You know, when I've got tabletop games, you would then imagine, you know, he says, right, I'm firing the cannon at you. All your guys got wiped out. What I would see is the cutscene in my mind. You know, all he did was he put the little circle on and killed three of my characters and took them off the board. And what I would see is like, watch out, it's incoming. And I would see all that in my mind. And I was like, wow, that's amazing. You know, even though we're just sitting there in my mom and dad's you know, coffee table, moving our little things across.
See,
I'd be seeing the cinematic thing, and that's got me excited.
Well, I think that a lot of people probably feel the same, because also in recent years, like, D&D has gotten like even more popular.
Oh, yeah,
I would
yeah.
say, like, online, mm-hmm. and like, it's very, very like, there's, I have gone to parties in LA where, like, you, it's, you know, people, it would be like the most stereotypical, like, LA party you could probably think of. You're like networking, you're kind of in this, and then it's like, there's no way this guy is like, this guy looks super cool. He's not like really nerdy at all. Like, doesn't have that like nerdiness mm-hmm. to him. Like we definitely have that like nerdy like vibe.
Yeah.
But they'll be like, you know, I always want to play D&D. I'm like, no shot. Yeah, but what are we doing it? Like, that kind of, I've never played D&D. I've always wanted to.
We could do a stream totally separately on role-playing games. Cause my first passion was role-playing games, miniatures, yeah. tabletop gaming, which, you know.
Well, it makes sense.
Yeah.
And it totally makes sense for you. Cause like that, you just, yeah, it's just imagining the world that you're in and imagining where you, like, what you're doing, even if you can't see every, it's like, you can almost feel the story around yeah. you, right? It's like the stereotypical, like, I feel like I, you know, there's many things you worked on where you walk in and you're like, oh, wow, I feel like this, I want to know more about what's behind that wall kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And you just sort of imagine it. And that's like, it's almost, it's sometimes even better when you don't see it at all.
Yeah.
And you just kind of,
you know,
go there in your head, and then community just goes crazy about certain things.
You know, we've talked about this, which is, you know, an art technique is sometimes drawing the negative space, not drawing the detail, drawing the gaps between detail. And in storytelling or design, you can also do the same thing. If I'm sure. drawing a potted plant, I might not try and draw the leaves. I might draw the spaces because I can see that, and then the plant comes out from it. You can do that same right. mentality in regards to
technique design. You right? take that from a micro level, take it to a macro level mm-hmm. with more, yeah. You know, a plant's not as interesting, but you take it to something yeah. else. Yeah, that makes sense. Like,
sometimes trying to obsess about the detail, you shouldn't. You should look at the spaces between the detail.
Yeah.
And then the detail will come through, right?
That's so cool. Yeah, that's a really good thought. It's like building out the, would you say, like the negative space,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
That's really cool. Yeah. That makes sense. There's a lot of stuff like that I like, for sure. I like how it was like...
And again, that's going back to our art principles and learning the rules. They're the ones that have some of the rules, right?
To the people that we're talking about, like, getting into the game industry and stuff like that. So, dude, this is like got to be like so... Like,
how long have we gone now? How have we done?
I've been live for 3 hours, but I brought you in at like 40 minutes in.
Okay.
And so we've been here for like a bit. What do you want to do?
No, I'm just checking, make sure everyone's okay. Because I'll just sit here talking to you for hours, but I want to make sure everyone's okay. We're entertaining them.
Chat is literally like, they're not going to want you to leave. They're not going to want you to leave at all. Chat, when I told you guys that it was just going to be a fun, vibing stream, I wasn't lying, dude. This was really cool. It's so funny because I think there's some people that keep coming in and they're like, they think this is not real or something. Mm-hmm. Or when we're playing the game and we're a little bit smaller on the screen.
Oh, a little purple heart. That's nice. I hope purple hearts are good. I hope it's not got like an internet meaning. Like, purple heart means we
that's
hate
just
you.
Like, that's just the Twitch heart. Okay. You're good. You're good.
Sorry. It's my narcissistic thing. They love me. I hope they love me. Please like what I'm doing.
I just, it's so funny. I always have you in this camera angle. And I'm just like, God dang it.
Well, you got a beard now.
That's true.
We've changed beards. It's like some sort of swap has happened.
I could go to glasses like if I want to too. I do this sometimes.
I have a beard. Okay, well, only one of us can have glasses at a time. Yeah, no. It's a model swap. We can only...
Emmy said I'm so jealous I'm not there. Yeah. Sucks, Emmy.
We're going to go trash the house. Woohoo!
Emmy, you know who is here? Your cats. They're waiting outside the door, and they've been curious for hours now what the heck is going on. So, Winter and Ellie definitely... That's so funny.
Remember, cats aren't just for Christmas. If you're lucky... Some will be left for Boxing Day. English joke there. Don't worry.
What does that mean? What does that mean? Like, what? What is he? They're like, when did I get a second cat? I don't even
know. Oh, there are multiple cats. Yeah.
There's two. There's two, chat. There's two. I don't know. Do you want to play anything else?
Sure, what else we got?
Vibe with more things? We can look at the shelf.
Yeah, let's go to the shelf.
The virtual shelf.
Let's go to my 80s bedroom, shall we?
Yeah.
Maybe
this
didn't
is
look
this
quite,
is way better than my 80s.
Yeah, maybe didn't quite look good. Oh my god.
It's funny, it's just, I tell these stories and think about it. It does sound like this kind of Monty Python joke of like, oh, it's, I used to live in a cardboard box under a bridge, you know? Yeah.
It wasn't that bad. So you said one of the first places that you got hired was Psygnosis. You said that?
Yeah, well, there was a small developer in town that I did, and I don't know, was I 15 or something? And they wouldn't employ me as a programmer, but I'd learned 3D Studio version 3 at the time. It was
sure.
It's going back, and so I said, "Well, I'm an artist," and so they hired me as an artist. So I was building models for the world, and then as I was doing that, I thought, "Well, now I'm building models because again, it's what they needed."
Yeah,
and they weren't going to trust a 15-year-old programmer to do things, right? So when I was doing that, I'd then be showing people, going, "I do some code." Oh, interesting. Okay, well, let's, and then so I could move over and do some coding, right? Because I was just like, I've got to get my foot in the door. I'll do anything to get, you know,
yeah,
to do that. But then, you know, a developer moved into town as well, which was a company called Digital Image Design. They did a game called TFX and EF2000, which was flight simulators and Inferno and stuff.
What?
These are old games on the PC. And yeah, once again, I would just hang around. There was a pub across the road from their dev studio. So I'd just hang there just to, because I could think like, oh, hello. Oh, you're a programmer. Oh, that's interesting. You know, I just wanted to be around it and hear it.
Yeah.
And yeah, and it was just kind of moving through there. And then, you know, again, summer holidays, then go to Psygnosis Manchester and Psygnosis Liverpool and then SCE doing testing and so forth. Yeah.
So when did you first... So all that's not America yet.
No, yeah. America's much later. It's really interesting when you hear, like, you know, Jason started his career, like, you know, when they hear about, they say like things like, oh, this person's an overnight success. And it's like, no, it took 20 years of doing Britsoft and doing games,
yeah,
in different places, finding who I was, finding out, learning it. Because when I went in there, I didn't know anything. I knew programming, I knew 3D packages. But the learning of this industry is in the industry, you know.
Sure.
And even like university courses, I'm not disparaging, I'm very encouraging of computer science game courses. But you only truly start to learn once you're in there, because when you're building a team, the difference between a new team and, let's say, an expert team is a shorthand of communication. As people work together, there's a shorthand that allows things to move rapidly,
yeah,
and ideas can move. That's one of the hardest things of starting up a new team, is to teach them to be comfortable with each other and move. So I had to learn all that, listen to what that looks like. And
sure.
So as you're doing projects and you get into difficult times, which you always do, how to respond to that. So that's what I was hungry for. That's the stuff I couldn't get from a book. That's why I just wanted to hear it.
Yeah.
So I was always like, how do I spend as much time as possible around these people? And I was just, they were, not to be too hyperbolic, but they were gods to me. Those guys, those old guys who were doing,
mm-hmm,
you know, the Mega Drive programming, because I came in too late for that. You know, I'm on the PS, you know, the Dreamcast and the Saturn, the PS1 and all that kind of stuff.
My baby, the Dreamcast.
Lovely machine. Lovely
gone
machine.
Too soon.
Absolutely. Lovely machine. Lovely machine.
That was...
But those guys who I'd kind of bump into were just my heroes. I just worshipped them because they... and I just was sitting there thinking, I'm so inadequate. I don't know how to do this stuff. I don't know how to do any of these things. And these guys are just walking around like nothing. And they were doing assembly language programming. And I was just like, oh my God. And I was like, I need to learn all that, you know? Yeah, it was magical. But I just wanted to be there. I just wanted to be around those guys. Every day was different. Every day was learning. Every day was stuff that I just come home and it's just like, I remember going to sleep. This sounds really funny. I remember going to sleep going, I just need to wake up so I can get back around. I just want to be there again, be,
yeah,
around them again, because I want to learn more. Yeah, it's amazing.
Dude, that's so cool. So yeah. you didn't move to America until long way out from when you,
yeah,
started.
Yeah,
long,
no,
way.
Yeah, I'd done the programming stuff for a bunch of time. I then got into production, started learning producing, started learning the business of games and,
sure,
how, and the broader kind of issues of games.
I think chat, this is something that I've noticed a lot, and chat, I think my chat's probably better with this, but I've always like, it. I actually didn't know until I got into the game industry what a producer does.
Mm.
Like that's one that I think that like a lot of people, it's hard to, maybe it's just me, but I think like,
when people think of like game developer, they think of like the programmer, they think of like the artist, right?
Yep.
They think of the more they think of the things that are sometimes easier to visualize.
To give you an idea, like, when I started, animators were the new boys. The idea of having an animator in your company was like, you don't belong here.
That's funny. Because like,
artists had only just been accepted. And I was talking to guys and they're like, yeah, we're okay now. Artists are part of the group now. Because programmers used to do the art, right?
Yeah.
And then we have artists who their job was art. So when I was coming in, animators were like, who do these guys think they are? You know? Now animation, obviously animation is a...
Yeah.
Obviously, right? But the same thing was happening with designers. The idea of a person who said, I'm a designer was not a thing at a certain point.
That's so weird.
The lead programmer was usually the producer as well. The lead programmer would decide what was going in, what was not going in. And producers would be like, I'm going to go get some food and stuff. But as projects got more and more complicated and you got more and more moving parts.
Then producer maybe goes to more the what you...
Now there's different cultures as well, just to say.
Sure.
Different studios have producers in a different function. Some have them as the arbiters of everything. Others have them as supportive staff on the side, right? And then you've got, you got your PCs, you've got your APs, you've got your Ps.
I always think of them as like producers. The train conductors, like, in a, or like the,
yeah,
they're like the ones like making sure everybody's on task and making sure that like the organization's good. And that might be.
Now there's times when that's true. Yeah. There's other projects. And again, it's the reason why there's no book that says this is how you make a game is it's about the people.
Sure.
And it's about the interplay of the people. Certain teams may be really proficient in one way and lacking another. And so the producers need to be a certain way. Like it's not just a book of this is what producers do. There's this range of skills, but you've got to view each team, see what you're trying to do, and then work out support, right? We talk about the timely, something like, big projects when you're talking about hundreds of millions of dollars and so forth, the production's usually associated to be the timely and qualitative delivery of the product as well. And that sounds a bit dry, but... when you've got, large sums of money going on, they want to go, hey, how are we doing?
Yeah.
Right. But again, sometimes you'll have the creative director or the director of the project will do that. Sometimes you want to hear that other voice that is dispassionate and clinical and just says, this is where we're up to. This is how many months we've got left and we've got to get there. Mm-hmm. And these are the...
The timeline.
Yeah. Yeah. So there is a value to having that distance. And that's when you get into EPs. So you got your EPs, you've got your SPs, right?
Yeah.
So the different levels are tighter to the team, but you sometimes need to have the guys that have a more the wider angle who can talk about this is our North Star, this is where we're heading.
Sure.
And then as you go closer down to the team, and this is how we get there, right?
Yeah.
Because they're now talking to the team and then feeding that information. And then connecting departments together, because communication becomes a challenge as your team gets bigger and bigger. And you've got multiple activities going on, single player, multiplayer.
I think that's something that it's hard for people. Like, you would never think about that challenge of it.
Mm-hmm.
People probably think of like, okay, well, actually, it's like people think of the very hands-on thing. Like, the things that you can easily say in like a word cloud, like engineering, art, like all this. Uh-huh. But it's like, there's so much intricacies of like how a team operates.
Yeah.
That people just don't like, and it's hard to even, I don't know how to even, like there needs to be like, just like more documentaries about games because so people can see what it's like more. Cause it's insane.
I've been writing down notes for like the last, like, I don't know, 10 plus years. I swear one day I should just put the book out, which is, because the books that are out about talking about games and games instruction and the managing them and so forth miss the human element. Like, the thing I'm talking about is this fuzzy thing. It's not it's not just like, here, do that and make the game. That's not the way it works. But there are, like, if you have a strong creative director, if you're, are you art-led and have more this kind of, and you're trying to, what the project's needs, the team should be constructed around its needs.
Yeah.
And production is one of those things that kind of slots in. Sometimes you don't want it to be very visible at all. It needs to be back here.
Yeah.
Other times it needs to be very integrated in there to help to move that. And then there's times when you're like, hey, you need to get out of your chair and go and speak to the other guy. And sure, you can get the producer to go and see him, but the power is between you two connecting.
Yeah.
And you need to know when one thing's applicable or the other thing's applicable, right?
That's so cool, dude, that insight.
God, I'm nerding out now on project management, eh?
So different. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Jason, you should try to make a book. Try to con-
and try content creation and teach people about game development and advice for those entering the industry, even as an online course.
I'm sure there's, I'm sure there's more experienced and better communicators out there who are probably doing it or have done it. I used to get really into like the management books and reading about it because a lot of, you know, the games industry's a, we forget this, but it's very young. Like compared to like the music industry or the film mm-hmm. industry, we're a very young industry.
It's young, but like...
Yeah, but we're moving
building,
so fast.
Building faster and faster all the time.
But, you know, you can go to like the automotive industry, management mm-hmm. stuff, the principles that they've learned that are way older than the movie industry, those principles are applicable. I think sometimes at games, you're like, well, we're all creative. And it's like, listen, those people had to be that as well.
Yeah.
Cars and other things yeah. had to be made. And there was, as more and more people were doing things, these principles are universal. But guess what? People are people, yeah. right? And they're doing a game one day. Maybe they're doing a building a bridge or doing something yeah. else, right? Those principles apply to all of us.
Oh my god, chat! I love this so much. Sif says this is crazy. We love you, Jason.
Oh, thank you.
Andrew said, "Wait, I just joined. What did I miss?" Oh my gosh. Okay, let's actually do one more of these games. At least okay. one more.
Yes, absolutely.
And then maybe we wrap up after that. After, I'm sure we go on one more tangent.
Tangents? Oh, it's not possible.
Tangents?
No.
Dude, all content creation is, Jason, is just going on a random tangent.
Yeah, you need to teach me this stuff. I don't know.
But I don't have to teach you because you already do it.
I don't know. I'm looking at this guy. What's going on?
He already talks like that, chat. I don't need to talk. Wait.
I'm in awe of how you do all this stuff. This is incredible.
Oh, like just all the...
Yeah, I love this stuff. Well, yeah. just... And how you're talking to everyone and keeping everything going. It's amazing.
Yeah, I can also do like...
Zoom. What's that?
Is it my Zoom? Zoom button. It's not placed correctly.
Well, so you can look at the power plug on the wall.
Yeah. Normally, I'd be like more
hey,
in the
Chad,
middle.
Do you want to see the power plug a bit closer? There you go. That's what we do. Whoa, got some duff there. Got some depth of field.
Oh, yeah. This lens is... You're just like in the camera angle, you just look so small.
Hello. Please let me out.
We can change the angle of you, but we're doing the stream the whole time this way, so. Okay, what was something we're...
What are we looking for? We're looking for two player, right?
Yeah. I'm not going to make you be Tails and...
I just realized what I was doing. I was looking to try and read the games like at home and I put them in there and I was like, it's printing it in front of
me. Yeah, they literally have the UI for it, yeah.
Looking past it.
Do we even have?
You need to do some fancy stuff. Forget when I'm here. You need to do old school fancy stuff.
Well, see, I we talked about this before. I when we were looking into doing the stream, I was like, oh, like I didn't even realize Fancy Star was like this. Like when I think of Fancy Star, I think of Fancy Star Online.
Okay.
And weirdly enough, Fancy Star Universe was one I played.
Okay.
Isn't that wild? Like I just never played like the actual OG like.
I remember like, it had the cartridge itself weighed more than normal cartridges because they put a memory chip in it so it could save, which was incredible. Because normally what you did was when you saved, it yeah. just gave you these you know strings of characters you'd have to write down. And if you forgot one or made a mistake, and my handwriting was terrible,
yeah,
that was it. Your save game was lost, right? you know, playing like games like King's Valley on the Konami games, and. Or Nightmare and things like that. But yeah, that had I think it was an EE problem, electrical, erasable, programmable, read-only memory chip that was in the thing. So it weighed more. And you're like, wow! Right? And so I could press save and I saved. Because otherwise it was onto tape as well. And you'd have to press play and record and then go and it would record it. And then you'd have to do load and press play and just pray to God it recorded it. And that's how you did save games on tape.
See, my equivalent to that is just like discs being scratched and just hoping that the scratch yeah. doesn't ruin the game.
Then the three floppies.
Oh, my thing was like, and people, I know some people in chat will have this. I had the, what do you call it? The Blockbuster. Because you could rent video games at Blockbuster all the time. And now Blockbuster's not really around anymore, and that's super interesting. But like, I would rent a game from Blockbuster. They had this thing where if you're a little bit late to returning it, they only charge you a little bit actually
nice.
At my Blockbuster. So I could keep a game for like 3 weeks, and I would just rent like all these different games.
Mm-hmm.
But every time, without fail, you take that thing and you're like, how is it this bad? Yeah. Like, how is it? Why does everyone take the disc out and put it on top? Why? Like, why don't you put it in the case? And I've seen people in chat before be thieves, and you've said, I don't remember what stream I was talking about, but someone was like, oh yeah, you guys said you would swap discs.
What?
Yeah, like somebody was like, I had...
Thievery!
Yeah, literally. I still
who are these people that you associate with here? What's going on here?
People in chat were like outed themselves the other day. They're like, yeah, I swapped the disc of another game. And can you imagine renting a game from Blockbuster? You think it's going to be this amazing thing you've been waiting for so long?
That's...
And you literally have...
That's no bueno.
That's we're not actual doing criminal that. Behavior.
No. Well, we didn't have Blockbuster. We had a video shop, and I used to go there, and I'd get all the martial arts films. I'd get all the, like, you know, Jackie Chan and stuff, you know, Operation Condor and stuff. I used to, you know, just love that. But I was like, what, 14? Like, and the manga stuff was all 18. But I had a little bit of facial hair when I was younger, as you might be able to tell, a bit of a hairy guy. And
let's
so
go.
I was the guy who'd go up there and go, you know, yes, I want Operation Condor. Are you 18? Yeah, yes, of course I am, yes. get all the martial arts movies to watch and take out.
See, I was just lucky because my dad was just so, like, he would just walk in there with me and be like, yeah, you can play. It's fine.
No, I had to sneak in there. I had to sneak in and fake my age. Yes, of course I'm old enough. Yes, please give me.
What is Toe Jam and Earl?
Oh, Toe Jam and Earl is awesome. Toe Jam and Earl's like, it's like an acid trip as a game. It's like this fat blob guy and thin guy. They're all kind of doing this. It's like Spot, the 7-Up game. It's the kind of Spot guy that moves like that.
What the?
Put Toe Jam and Earl on. Go on.
Is it single player?
Yeah, it is. No, I think it's two players though. Oh my god, I don't even remember. Toe Jam and Earl.
Someone in the chat said Toe Jam and
Earl. Oh, I love Toe Jam and Earl. Yep. Great. Yeah. Look at these guys.
What?
Yep.
Oh, he has a... Toe Jam has a gold chain that says TJ.
Nice.
That's some crazy attention to detail. Like, did they need that? Greetings. Oh, wait.
Two player. I do not remember. I remember this, but yeah.
Should I just press two and see what happens?
Go on.
Random world.
Oh my god. Yeah.
What? What? It says we're wieners.
Makes sense.
What is this?
Am I dancing? Is that me dancing?
You're like emoting.
I don't know, dude. Oh my god. This is going back.
What? I can't even... Why is it stopping when I press...
These are the games you get and you go, what is this I'm playing? I thought you were gonna go with Echo the Dolphin. I'm gonna go Echo the Dolphin.
Oh, I should put Echo. I have no idea what this is.
We're gonna go in the elevator.
Is that a hotel?
What is it? I'm gonna go in the elevator. I think we're about to go to a different part of the map, maybe. There we go. I mean, that's, you know, going back to the LucasArts games, right? Things like Day of the Tentacle.
I don't know what that is.
Day of the Tentacle?
Chat, what is that? Chat, what is that? I just got booed. Booed.
And rightly so.
Does he not know about the classic Toe Jam and Earl? No.
Oh, I remember playing it, but I was, you know, well... I was like 13 at the time, or something.
I don't understand what this is. How do I fight?
You play Monkey Island?
No.
Jay, he's so disappointed in me. Why did a moment like this have to happen?
I have not. I know what it is, though. I'm not playing it.
You gotta play Monkey Island now.
I have not played Monkey
Island. Oh my gosh. Have you talked to him? I, you know, this is like Full Metal Jacket, you know. I'm not braving you, Private Pile. It's all you guys. You need to be steering him straight onto the... Give him a proper games education.
Friendship with Jason. That's literally like... here's the other thing. I've told you this before. I spent so much of my life.
Jason's about to get so pretentious. Oh, I've already started like about an hour ago. Don't worry about that.
I've spent so much of my life making videos about your game.
Oh, okay then. I'll let you off. That's my only
response is like, because chat will know. There was like an era where like when I started doing like variety streaming and everything, chat was like, JC, you haven't played this? And I'm like, no, I've just been literally just making videos about like
zombies every day. I'm actually reconsidering my previous statements. No, please keep playing the games I make, because that's
true.
What am I talking about? Sending people to all these other games. Yeah, no. Keep going back to our games.
No, yeah, I just haven't.
Go and do a single player. Finish up with a bit of Echo the Dolphin.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah, this. I like how you immediately were just like, yeah, this game is
weird. I remember this being very weird at the time. Like, iconic, but weird.
Well, it's in here. It's on the shelf. Where's, yeah.
You got Echo, surely? Yeah. Oh, Altered Beast. Oh, Altered Beast.
What was that? Oh, yeah, you mentioned that at the beginning.
Yeah, you turn into like a different monster. You keep going to ESWAT. Don't keep baiting me with ESWAT.
Wait,
no. Where's Echo? Echo's gone.
Is it not here?
Oh, come on.
There might not be Echo.
No?
No, because it would be under E, right?
That's normally where you put it.
They have ESWAT, though.
Okay, what else? Let's have a look.
I remember playing Comic Zone.
Alex Kidd was the skateboarding one, if I remember rightly.
Yeah, that's... Yeah. Alien Soldier at Alex Kidd and the Enchanted...
In Casco.
There you have.
What's that one?
Kid Chameleon.
Yeah. You know what? You can finish off with a bit of Sonic.
No way.
You can have a bit of Sonic.
Oh, you know what I should do? Let's do something different. Let's do Sonic 3D Blast.
There you go.
Chat, he gave me permission.
Not a clue. I've ever seen this one.
Actually?
Yeah.
This was like the first... Was this the first
3D? Traveler's Tales, yeah. This is the same guys who do the Walking Dead game back in the day. Traveler's Tales, yeah.
So this one was... It's not as refined as like Sonic Adventure, which is funny because Sonic Adventure's not... Like, Sonic Adventure's very rough around the edges as well, but okay. But this was like... What, one of the... Is this the first 3D? I don't know, chat. I didn't play this one that much. I got Flickies, though.
Did I get the studio wrong? Did I just... I thought... Well, maybe. Okay.
Maybe you did.
Sorry. Oops. Oh, yes. I remember seeing this. I didn't play it, but I remember seeing
it. It's weird, because it's just on that edge of 2D and 3D. It's like you can tell that they're just experimenting with it.
See, that reminds me of Marble Madness.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. Bit of,
and I think the goal, if I remember, was... There's little secrets for more rings, but I think...
It's like 2.5D, right? Isometric.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Do you see, like, the flickies on the bottom right?
Okay, yeah.
It's like those little boxes. I think you have to find... Like, it's about finding them in the sort of open zone or whatever you're in.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can escape. So it's like it's essentially finding the keys and then getting out. And I guess there's I don't remember what boss fights happened. And that's the exit, but you can't go until you have to like throw the flickies into the into the ring.
Okay.
But I don't know where the heck. I'll try to get one or two of them. Oh my god. The audio is great though. Dude, Sonic games, the audio is so good. Gotta save the birdies always. Always. Yeah, there was a Sonic game, yeah. Oh, let's see, there's one. Yeah, I found one. I don't know, you just run around. Maybe it's they're in the enemies, too? Oh my god. Oh, it's so hard to control. Oh, yep, see, there's one.
you got controller feedback, have you?
Yeah. It's really hard. That's what you do.
Right.
And then you probably go on this really fast. Oh.
Do they stay with you if you go on it?
Yeah, they should.
Yep, there you go.
There's this guy. Oh my gosh, I haven't played this game in so long. There you go. And then,
the key's to looking at your shadow, right, to see where you are in the parallax, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's gotta be one more, but is it this? No? Chat?
Someone in the chat has to know, where's the last flicky? Just let me do this one level at least. I used to struggle with this game. Yeah, it's a hard one, to be honest. Because it's like, later they're just like, yeah, just get to the end of the level. Mm-hmm. And that's what you should do. Oh, there we go.
Oh, he's aggressive.
Oh! Oh, bugs. Let me see if I can like... Yeah.
There
you go. Purple, yep. Purple flicky. And then you go up here. And you go over here. And you go... Oh, I thought that animation is really cool though. It just grabs on.
He's throws
on
the ring.
Nice. Is that it?
Oh, you gotta get in. Oh.
What?
Alley-oop. Gotta jump up on.
Chat? Oh, I left one? Oh, he got lost.
There he is.
Hey, hello. There you go. And then Sonic goes, nice. He doesn't say anything. And then you teleport to the next area. It's so cute.
That's awesome.
Yeah. That's a good one to end on. We've been here a while.
Retro.
Retro.
Retro Wednesday.
Retro Wednesday. 5 minutes Sonic gameplay. Dude, but to be honest with you, that's most Sonic games. The levels are about 5 minutes, and they designed them that way. They want it to be quick. Jason's my spirit animal.
Follow me.
Retro just means outdated. Does it? No.
Yeah.
No,
that's harsh.
Yeah, that's
harsh.
I feel like it's retro's more like, I don't know, I guess
the old school.
Yeah, old school.
Yeah.
But when does something enter retro?
Mm.
Like
when I'm invited to talk to someone, they keep on telling me how old I am. Yeah. that's when it's retro. Didn't seem retro when I was thinking about it.
Do you think that like that's so weird to think about. I'm just thinking about
you will have this moment. You have this moment when you're going to be playing games and some guy's going to say, oh, those are classics. Yeah, like, I remember as a kid when I was playing that, and you're going to go, oh, God.
Yeah, oh. Like I have a, like, me and Emmy have a kid one day.
Mm-hmm.
And I go, oh, man, this is a classic, Mom of the Dead or something. Mm-hmm. And then would that be considered retro?
Yeah, I
like 30 years from now.
I remember like a lot of the old games.
Not them having a kid in 30 years. That's
a lot of the games I kind of, you know, you play on your phone, right? These old ones.
Yeah.
I remember, you know, when we were doing Call of Duty games, I said, listen, remember everybody, there'll be a point when this game will just run on a phone and be a retro game. It'll be nothing compared to the hardware that can run in the same way that these are to right. now. They'll make emulators and put it on because it's just nothing to it.
Yeah.
That's
weird to think about. That's like existential stuff. Mm-hmm. That could send me down a... Yeah. A long rabbit hole.
Yeah. As long as Moore's Law doesn't stop us, you know.
What does that mean?
Well, silicon power kind of doubles, you know, on time. Mm. So that's the idea. It's going to keep going. But at some point, the transistors can all get so small before you start getting bleed and things. So, but they've got other ways to kind of get over that. So if it keeps going the way it's going, then yeah, this will, all our 3D and then high graphics will just be able to run on a phone for nothing.
Right? Damn. Chat. I don't know what else. I think we're both winding down now. This is it. our social social meter is.
This is more talking than I've done in my. I don't know how you do this.
We go on for hours.
Mm.
Hours.
I get too self-conscious. I feel like.
Yeah, that happens a lot too. But you kind of roll with it. The longest stream I ever did. It's like, I think I streamed for like 30 hours.
Wow.
And it was solving an Easter egg.
Was that my fault?
Yeah, it was your fault.
Okay, I'm sorry about that. That's the apology.
It was right before I went to college though. So like I had all the time in the world. Mm-hmm. But I remember my dad was just like, what are you doing?
Not now, Dad!
Not now! Emmy's been streaming a lot lately. She's had longer streams, but I always make fun of her because there's this mark of time when someone hasn't streamed a lot. It's usually around 2 hours.
Okay.
You hit the 2 hour mark.
Yeah.
And your brain goes, I don't know why. It always happens. Like Emmy will go live. She's so into it, and then when she starts winding down, I'm like,
wait, how long are you in the stream for? Just like 2 hours. I'm like, oh, okay.
If I was going to do this, I'd just have like a, you know, well, I'm going to be all English and say I'd have a pot of tea there, right? Yeah. But a cup of coffee, pot of tea. I just go, bang.
Yeah, I feel bad. Do you have enough water?
Oh, I'm good. Great.
Okay.
It's great.
Oh, Chad. Jason has become a streamer.
No. I'm about to disappear back into the mists of time in a second.
Well, I don't know. Is there anything else you want to talk about? Anything else you want to say? Like, it was just a pleasure to chill out with you.
Well, cheers.
Have good vibes.
Thanks for inviting me. And thanks for all the people watching and having patience to listen to us nattering on. I hope it was entertaining in some way.
Yeah. Chat, like, I appreciate you guys. I know that it's very different kind of stream for sure, but it's one of those like things where like I'm just very thankful that you guys are like as chill and cool as you are. I couldn't keep up to date with chat the whole time, but for the most part I think it was, everybody was super nice and kind in here and really, really supportive and vibing with all of the old knowledge.
Sure.
That I actually love. Like, I need to go back and like listen to a lot of things, like just because you're like, you're almost like melting my brain a little bit at times.
Oh, don't listen to any of that stuff. That's just me, you know.
Yeah, but in like a good way, you know.
What do they say? Don't let the truth get in the way of a good story.
Yeah. It's just like there's some of these things where I'm like, I don't know what that word is, but I wanna know more about, like, I would love to dive in more sometime. It'd be fun. It'd be very, very fun.
You got my number, give me a call.
Yeah. Yeah, we could. If you're down to this any time again in the future, I'm sure chat would love it.
I think I need to smoke bomb, disappear for a while.
That's okay. We're just happy to see
you. But as Arnie used to say, I'll be back.
We'll be back one day, chat. We'll be back. He's not very, like, Jason's not very social media-y.
Oh, no.
I don't know if that's a word.
I have to say this every time I appear. If there's any account anywhere that says, oh, this is Jason's account, no, it's not. I never have and will not have. So if you're ever following anyone and say, this is Jason's account, no, it ain't.
I know a couple of those accounts, and I know some of the people that run them. And so, yes. Like, yeah, that's very funny. A lot of people are just saying, like, thanks very much, Jason, for being an amazing man. You and creativity jumpstart my career in education and storytelling, changed the way I looked at history. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh, always puts a smile on my face. I love a like chat. There's nothing to plug. It's just having fun. That was the goal of this stream.
And that was lots of fun.
By the way, it was very fun.
They're taking me back there. I've not played these games in a long time, and it's wonderful. Great.
Yeah. No.
This might have ignited me to. Start playing all the old games again now. I'll have to dig up the old MAME emulator and start playing all the old games. I might even go further back to the 8-bit days, which is...
Yeah, yeah, see, that's what I'm curious about too. I want
to... See, the thing is, back in those days, you didn't have graphics to save you, so your game had to be fun. It had to work, right?
Yeah.
It's like we were talking about with storytelling. The old stories, they had to work in the spoken word, so it was always the most succinct way of telling a story. If you go back to the 8-bit days, simple gaming, the game had to work. Because the graphics weren't going to wow you, so the mechanics had to work, right?
It's like,
I mean, there's lessons in there, there's things in there.
Even when you go back to, like, you know, it's going to sound so cliche to say, but like when you go back to like Pong or something, mm-hmm. right? It's like, well, it's not that interesting looking.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it was at the time, but like, but it's that, it's just the, that, what, second to second gameplay of Pong that was just, that was it.
Mm-hmm.
Boom, it works. Everybody loves it.
If you look at Pong, there's so many decisions that have to be made. You know, okay, what's the length of the thing? You know, mm-hmm. What's the speed of the paddle? You know, how does that start off? There's so many design decisions that took place, even in such a simple game.
Right? My favorite thing
in television, right? Back, and that was that's when you could plug into your TV and go, wow, there's my TV is now turned into a games machine. Yeah. Wow, that's incredible.
Something that was really cool looking at today is because I always tell you that everybody is like so like short form content brain nowadays.
Yeah.
You know, with you know, all these social medias now are all just short form content. Even YouTube's using shorts and all this sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And so I always like when I'm thinking about like when you're thinking of like retention and like getting people to like keep playing, it's like I always worry that it's like, oh my God, it's even more now. It's even people get bored even quicker now. But something that I thought was interesting is that when we were playing Alien Storm, that the way that level was built was actually pretty quick,
And it feels like the actual rhythm of like how that level was, it wasn't like we were sitting here for like 10 minutes doing the first set piece. It was a couple of minutes. We were on to a running section. A couple minutes, we were on to a shooting gallery section. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh, that's kind of like, that would be like I'm rethinking my brain. I'm like, wait, have we always been this way where like that works, where you just having that variety in always just works at that level?
You know, the technique of, you know, burst of flavors, you know, the idea of giving you a sample of stuff and then you can kind of go to a longer form. You know, there was times when people were saying, well, Community and Generations now, they can't keep complex characters or multi-line storylines going. And then you're like, well, Game of Thrones just completely disproved that, which was there was mass appeal in complex stories, complex characters over time. So again, we've got to not fall into the trappings of start going, oh, everybody just likes short form. It's like, no, if you make something that's compelling and rich,
sure,
the audience will come and see it, right? Or engage in it. And sometimes you don't always get the initial, you know, sometimes it builds and you've got to be able to stick with something to let the community grow on an idea, right?
Yeah.
So,
dude, I love it. Oh, yeah, yeah. I think we all learned. We all learned a little bit of something today, which is good.
Me too.
Jason just wanted to show him whooping JC in the Streets of Rage
with a pipe. Just
that happened a lot in the stream chat. But yeah, I mean, everybody. I don't know if you've been seeing the chat scroll by, but everybody's just been really like happy and supportive. And chat, I'm sorry that I haven't gotten to all like the donos and everything. I was just like trying to make sure the stream was really, really good. But like, I appreciate all y'all so much. I really, really do. No womp womp. No. Don't say that word. It's just, it's not a bad thing. It's just a sound effect. They just think it's cute when someone says womp womp. No whisper. No, we're not doing that.
I'm not dancing for you.
That's what they do. It's literally like dance, monkey.
Come on, creator.
Yeah, like
say the words we want.
You have to see us right now. No womp womp, chat. No.
You just got one there. You've already been.
Oh, I did.
I can't say it because if I say it, then
they go,
we got you.
Yeah, we don't need that. Yeah. We don't need that. That doesn't make any sense. Chat, I think that's going to do it. This is really fun. Thanks for coming, man.
Thanks, man.
For real. I love it.
Thanks for inviting me.
Dude, it's of course. I can't believe you said yes to chill out.
It's been great fun.
Yeah. We definitely went longer than we thought we were gonna go to.
Yeah.
I feel like we did dabble in a lot of different subjects too. We kinda went.
Well, once we cut these guys off, we'll carry on. We'll carry on playing.
Yeah. Bye bye, chat. No, I'm just kidding. What a great stream. You should invite him back somebody to hear some anecdotes like this. Aw, cute. Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Whatever you're doing, I hope you're happy with it.
Oh.
Sidious, so you. you get the fog rolling in. Can't escape it.
It's going to stay with me for a while, I think.
Yeah. All right, chat. That's going to be it. Thank you all for being here. Look, the beauty of these streams is I don't tell you when stuff like this happens. It's hilarious. You guys lived in this moment. We'll always remember. Thanks for being here, guys. I tried to give you a heads up a little bit. I was teasing a little bit. And I was going like, oh yeah, like retro games. It's going to be really fun. Fun. And they're like, what is he? But I knew like I had to play retro games. I had to bring somebody who actually knew what to talk about because I don't know what to talk about.
I had to bring an old person.
Sorry, that comes across so bad.
No, it's good.
Oh man. All right, chat. This is. Oh yeah, this can go on YouTube. Totally fine. I'm sure people will probably put it on YouTube anyways, like without my permission, and that's fine. But yeah, I'll upload it to YouTube, chat. No worries. But yeah, guys, have a wonderful rest of your day. Jason, thank you very much for being here.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for
vibing
with me. And yeah, chat. Thanks for vibing with us and just talking about nerdy game stuff.
Long live the nerds.
Rise. Bye guys. Bye.
See you later.
Really fun stream chat. Bye. I've just been like no music, so it's just kind of like us talking, but it's fun. Y'all too, have a good one, chat. Bye. There you go. There's all the hearts and emotes. One last hearts for Jason chat. One last time. Let the emote wall go. Watch it. It'll happen. There it is.
Oh, lovely. There Thank it is. You. Thank you very much.
Bye, chat. Have a good one.